by Molson, bringing you the finest in hockey broadcasting for 25 years. Canadian Tire. There's more to Canadian Tire than tires. Seiko. People trust Seiko more than any other watch. Esso. Responding to your needs makes us better. You make us better. And by Ford of Canada. At Ford, quality is job one, right down the line.
The Minnesota North Stars try to move to the Norris Division Final, and the Leafs try to move in their way. Good evening, everyone. I'm Dave Hodge with Leaf captain Rick Vibe. The record says that Vibe has taken 9 shots in this series. The record doesn't say he's hit 2 goalposts. It does say he doesn't have a goal. And logic says you have to start scoring for the Leafs to win and extend this series. Well, what you need is better luck, I would think. That's about all.
Well, I think just a few breaks going our way would turn it around. In Minnesota, I wasn't the only guy to hit goalposts. I think we hit about 9 in total in 2 games, and that just shows the breaks weren't going our way. So hopefully the breaks will turn around tonight.
If you continue to play as hard as you did in Minnesota and as well as you did, there's really not much more the coach can ask. Can he ask you or tell you to play any differently at home?
I don't think so. I think we played 2 very good hockey games in Minnesota. I think the only difference possibly that maybe we could take it to them a little more in our home building and do a little more hitting. But other than that, you couldn't ask for any more effort from all 20 guys.
That suggests some action right off the bat in the first period of this game. For more on tonight's contest, let's join our commentators in the broadcast booth, Bob Cole and Mickey Redmond.
Well, there you go, Mickey. Rick Vibe said it all. They cannot play any harder than they did in the first 2 games, yet they have come up empty. But really, Mickey, I believe that line of Derlego, Anderson, and Vibe, for the Leafs to win, they just got to get some goals.
I think you're right, Bob, and I think Vibe is right. If I was Mike Nicoluk, I would ask for the same type of effort that they got in the 2 games in Minnesota, but definitely the 2 top scorers on the team, Vibe and Anderson, they've got to get some goal production out of them, and maybe a little more steady goaltending, let's say, from Mike Palmateer. He's played well, but he has had a couple of bad goals on him. If they get all that tonight, I think they'll have a good chance to beat the North Stars.
You know, it's been a physical series thus far, if you can believe it. It could be even tougher tonight. Jim Corrin had a bit of fire in his eyes this morning, didn't he?
He sure did. I think we're out for a dandy tonight.
Here's Dave.
The North Stars would like to sweep it in 3 straight games. That is quite obvious. They look ahead if they win this series to St. Louis or Chicago, and the Blackhawks are even with the Blues at a game in that series. The Leafs would like to take on the winner of that series as well. We'll find out what happens in Game 3 shortly as we return with our Stanley Cup playoff coverage on CBC in just a moment.
There are a lot of great sports in Canada. And at Molson's, we believe there are a lot of great reasons to support them. Fitness, entertainment, competition, and the pursuit of excellence. That's why we're committed to bring you the best in sports and special events. We're Molson Brewers, and we support great sports in Canada.
The Maple Leafs hope that home ice can make a difference and can propel them back into this series, and they'll have vocal support from a Maple Leaf Gardens crowd that has been called dull in previous seasons and in previous games this season, but this is going to be a loud audience tonight at Maple Leaf Gardens. We'll be keeping you up to date on the highlights of the Montreal at Buffalo game. The Sabres trying to end that series. The Canadiens trying to score a goal in that series. It is scoreless midway through the first period at the Auditorium in Buffalo. And this afternoon, the Islanders defeated Washington 6-2 to take a 2-1 lead in that series. Bourne and Trache scoring 2 goals each for the defending Stanley Cup champions. Let's go now to Bob and Mickey.
They're usually quiet here in the gardens, but tonight a standing ovation for the Toronto Maple Leafs as they came out onto the ice. They're just about set to get Game 3 underway, folks. And there's really no need to remind anyone that for the Leafs, this is it. No tomorrow and all that stuff. Well, just a few minutes ago, Leaf General Manager Jerry McNamara said definitely there will be a tomorrow. And as a matter of fact, game time is 7 p.m. Eastern. Well, we'll see. The crowd standing here, and you can tell from the faces of the coach, like Nicoluk, and the players that they're loving it.
The organ and saying, oh, Canada.
The starting lineups are there. And here's our national anthem. close tonight. The referee is... officials tonight from Boston, Mickey Redmond, the goaltenders.
Well, Bobby, once again, Donnie Beaupre will be starting in the nets for Minnesota. We're going to look at Mike Palmas here first. Again, for the Leafs, Mike is 10-4-1 in his last 15 games here at Maple Leaf Gardens. And, of course, the Leaf fans hope that he can continue that surge here tonight. And there's Donnie Beaupre to our left in the north end of Maple Leaf Gardens. He is 14-4-3 in his last 21 games. Very, very well. And his management and coach very happy with the way he's playing.
Therrien, Podubny, and Preacher for the Maple Leafs starting against Eaves with Payne and Bellows. Eaves moved up as Tim Young is out of the lineup. A knee injury from game two in Minneapolis. Leafs with Salming and Benning on the defense, and Salming is coming back. He's in there with Bellows watching him. Played off the boards, but not out. Eaves kept it in. There's Bellows. He's bumped by Therrien. Bellows sliding it in front. A quick shot. Didn't come off, really, as Eaves fanned on it. And two Leafs race out. Preacher coming in. Therrien missed the pass. Podubny is offside. And it's called at the North Stars blue line.
Well, Bob, there's a couple of gentlemen who are not in the lineup tonight. Dan Daou on your left. Dave Farish on the right. Farish with a bad back. And bad news for the Leafs. Dan Daou, Bob told me this morning, he is not going to be able to skate for at least 6 weeks. So he is definitely gone for the playoffs as far as the Leafs should go. Other scratches tonight. Reed Bailey is not in the lineup. Norman Aubin and Paul Higgins. And, of course, Peter Inacek with that cut in his thigh. And Gary Nyland with a knee injury.
Now Bobby Smith, the hero for the North Stars so far in the series, with McAdam and Klett on the wings. A long shot by Hartsburg grabs. The Leafs have Martin with Boudreau, number 12 at center, and Billy Harris. Melrose on the defense. Moving up with Jim Korn. But now the North Stars try to get it going. They shoot it down the ice. Korn going back against Smith. Smith is in first, so no icing. Smith in the corner, bumped by Melrose. Boudreau cleared it outside the line. And the fans responding to that heavy hitting down there to the right of Paul Mateer. Now the Leafs grabbing the puck as Boudreau stopped at the blue line. 1:20 gone to the first period. So far, so good for both goaltenders. Nothing has happened. The Stars have had one shot. They're hitting hard already in this first period. Smith stopping one, coming in. The shot kicked out by Paul Mateer. Harris grabs it. North Stars are changing. Harris to Martin. That did not work. Hartsburg again shooting it in. North Stars trying to take over in the early going of this game three of this Norris Division semifinal game. The North Stars, of course, leading the series 2-0, can win it tonight. Long shot, stopped by Paul Mateer. It's into the crowd as Ferguson let it go.
Boy, Jim Korn just took a heavy hit from Al McAdam down in the corner. There's Lou Nanny behind the North Star bench. Bob Korn went directly to the Toronto bench. He went in head first from a check from McAdam. Boy, they need another injury, boy. Like, they need to lose another hockey game, I'll tell you. They've really been hurt. This crowd seems to have taken a page out of the North Star fans' book. They're really behind the Leafs here tonight.
Ferguson. Jordy Douglas is number 14. As Ferguson got the draw, went in close. In front of the net, that's Douglas. Spun around. Priest, 31. Couldn't get a shot away. Now Priest going in again with Roberts. In front of the net. It's called back at the blue line. It had been called. Apparently nobody heard the whistle. And Wayne Bonney, the linesman on this side, had called the play back out. 2 minutes and 14 seconds into the first period, Mickey. And the three shots on goal so far, all by the North Stars. Beaupre hasn't touched it yet. That's Salming behind the net. Leafs starting slowly, trying to move it up. This time, they're let go with Anderson and Vibe. Vibe going in on that right wing. He's knocked down. Crowd responding. They will be called. No penalty. Just that the puck was smothered. It'll come outside the line.
A lot of heavy hitting, Bob, right in the early going. Captain Vive, back-to-back 50-goal years, 54 last year and 51 this year. The big fella's got to start to get some production. good chances in the first two games in Minnesota, but just not bouncing his way. There you see Vibe getting knocked over by Jordy Douglas. Just to finish off on the injuries, Bob, I sit in a check with a cut thigh. Of course, that's a calf muscle cut that he has. For Minnesota, Gary Sargent knee, Fred Barrett finger, and Tim Young knee are out of the lineup tonight.
Salming pinching in, couldn't get the puck call. Shingra in the lineup again. After missing game two in Minneapolis, still has a sore knee, but as he said today at the light skate the Leafs held here at the Gardens, I don't care what happens, I'm playing tonight. Well, he's on the ice now. Number 11, Gaston Shingra. Salving now, coming out. The Stars are changing, the Leafs moving. Anderson got the pass in with Therrien. Anderson, they crowd him out of the play. And the North Stars, Cicerelli coming back with Broughton. Broughton going in. Kathy with him. Broughton had it poked away by Salming. Played back near the line. Therrien can't find it. Now he does. Hooked it coolly back in his own. Look at this one by Therrien. Creature to Anderson, who's still on there. It's all the way back. Shand is number four. The Leafs moving up the center ice. Playing it in. That's Creature in front of the net. Coming to the fourth minute of the first period. No score. Broughton getting away. Leaves it for McCarthy. Cicerelli with him. Cicerelli on the boards. Put the swing on it. Therrien carrying it to the board. Therrien with Creature and Podubny. The pass hit Creature's skate. They're a little shaky in the early going of this hockey game. Both teams passing a little shaky, but now Hartsburg shot stop. McCarthy coming in. Right close to the net. Couldn't get a second shot at it. Creature will bring it out. Here he is to center ice. Shan going off. Creature shot. Stopped by Beaupre. Creature, outstanding forward for the Maple Leafs so far in this series. Causing some problems for the North Stars for Chuck and Martin. Here's Creature with Boudreau in front of the net. Creature got it in front. Down goes Beaupre. And he hangs on to it. Little pushing and shoving for the linesman and the referee in quickly. From Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto, this is Stanley Cup 83 on CBC.
It's the call of the wild. And Ford answers with Bronco 2. It's a completely new, smaller Bronco, built tough. With four-wheel drive and a V6 with more power than any competitor. It's smaller outside and more maneuverable, but roomy inside. With full four-passenger comfort and style. See it now at Ford and Mercury dealers. The new Ford Bronco 2.
23-year-old Miroslav Creature, 5 points, Bob Cole. In the first two hockey games, he's been outstanding.
He has been great.
Goal and four assists.
4:30, two gone. In the first period, no score. They've just posted the baseball score today. The Jays defeating the New York Yankees here in Toronto, 7-4. Harris into the faceoff spot now against Eves. Harris got the draw, but the North Stars jump on it. Payne knocked it back into the corner for Maxwell. Leafs have Boudreau, Martin, and Harris. Eves in between Payne and Bellows for Minnesota. That could be a heavy line for the North Stars tonight. On the clear out of the net, put it high on the glass. Harris can't clear it out. Now they do. They knock it out to center ice. That came off the stick of Salming. They've hit the 5-minute mark of a scoreless first period. Salming backs up in his own zone. Boudreau missed the pass. Bellows to Payne, back to Maxwell. And the Stars come back to regroup. Maxwell flipped it on the far side for Payne. Salming has him covered. Salming in there quickly. It comes in front of the net. Anthony Harris gets away. Tree leads to center. This is Martin coming in with Boudreau. Martin couldn't get the shot through Maxwell, who fell, and he blocked it. Sweeping back out is Eves. He's up over the Leaf line with Bellows shooting it. That's wide of the Leaf net. And Harris again down the right side. Martin going off those. The Leafs make changes. And the North Stars pick it up, and they come in with it. Giles is bumped right away by Anderson. Five and Derlego. Derlego shot right on. Beaupre, long shot, made the save. Shot is 3-2 Minnesota at this point. Now they're bumping a little bit inside the line. Five and Derlego. Bobby Smith going down to the ice. And a check by Derlego. Here he comes again to hit him. Got him at the blue line and tied him up and sent him to the ice again. Anderson coming in. Anderson around Smith. He's got to be tired now. Smith has the puck, though. The puck. Smith bumped again by Jimmy Corrin in behind the play. Really roughed him up. Look at this. McAdam is bumped by Corrin. Here comes Corrin with Bobby Smith taking right hands.
Look at this. Flett dumps Vive. Back away from the play right now. Corrin and Bobby Smith going at it. And Flett is challenging Ricky Vive. He knocked him flat in his rear end. And they're having the trouble to get them away. Look at Vive and Flett now. The stick's up in the air. Boy, now Corrin wants to get at Flett. You knew this was coming, Bob.
They played 6 minutes and 25 seconds of the first period, and you kind of wondered, Mickey, when it was going to break out.
Well, you knew it was going to happen before the hockey game. The Vive downer, he's really incensed. Jawing with Bobby Smith now, but well, we have not seen the end of this, I'll guarantee you.
Tonight's Stanley Cup playoff game is coming to you from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto.
In the world of action watches, trust Seiko for advanced dual display technology even 300 feet beneath the sea. Trust Seiko for watches that display any of six timekeeping functions with a turn of the bezel. For alarm chronographs that even measure your pulse rate. Seiko watches and clocks, the most advanced performers in timekeeping. No wonder people trust Seiko more than any other watch.
Well, here at 6:25 of the opening period, the Leafs, Jim Corrin, draws a major. 5 minutes for fighting. And Smith, 2 minutes, a minor penalty.
That's how it all started right there, Bob. Innocent enough, but Jim Corrin decided to go after Smith right away. There you see the other two right behind there, Vive and Flett. And with Corrin going after Smith, Flett decided to try to razz up Ricky Vive, and they almost got at it. But the Maple Leafs have come out on the losing end of this so far with those 5 minutes for Corrin and only two to Smith.
Stanley Cup update game tonight is over in Buffalo. The Montreal Canadiens on the brink of ending it all tonight. If Buffalo can win it, we'll have highlights of that game for you. No score there yet. No score here. During the 7 minute mark of the opening period. That's Therrien stealing it with Preacher. One man back. Therrien right in. Therrien with two or three efforts before that one was behind Beaupre. 1-0 Toronto Maple Leafs.
Well, the little guy does it all so far for Toronto in this series. That's his first goal, but look at him take the puck away from Steve Payne. They break in 2-on-1 with Creature. He uses Creature as a decoy and takes two or three whacks as Beaupre left his goal post position. And there you see him bank it off the right toe. Beaupre and the Leafs have got the lead. And a happy crowd here at the Gardens. Listen to the noise they're making here, Bob. Amazing.
Great effort by Therrien. Look at that second effort. Unassisted goal at 6:49. 1-0 Toronto. Now then, Salming from center shooting it in. Leads for Lego. Into the corner. Hit by Skate. He's around the net to pick it up. To Salming. A shot. Right in front it goes. Here's Vive grabbing it again. He's bumped by Hartsburg. Vive still looking for the puck though against Giles. Vive coming up with it, falling, getting back up again. Eyes Salming back here, trying to get it back to him, but it was intercepted by Broughton. Out to center for Minnesota. Broughton up the line, coming in McCarthy. Salming blocked that shot coolly. In back of the net, Gingras. Gingras can't get away from Broughton. Gingras after, pinning him on the boards. Here comes Salming. The puck is loose, so the play will continue. And it's Salming. Bumped by McCarthy. But two Leafs. It's Vive. And Derlego in the center ice area. Now Derlego is going off. Vive trying to hook it in to the Minnesota zone. Put it up high over the glass. And they'll get changes all around.
Boy, they're belting. They are belting each other. There's the goal scorer, Greg Therrien. Great individual effort as he just stole that puck away from Steve Payne. But you can see, Bob, that the Leafs are doing exactly what Rick Vive thought they could do, and that was take it to Minnesota a little more here at Maple Leaf Gardens. They are doing that, and the fans absolutely love it.
Now, Bobby Smith has just 35 seconds left in his penalty, And then Jim Corn, of course, will have another 3 minutes on the major. Assessed him. Then we'll see what will happen as the Leafs will be shorthanded. Right now for Toronto, Anderson is number 10. To his left is Shan. Melrose is the other defenseman. And Preacher is up front with Anderson. Eaves for Minnesota. Maxwell, the defenseman, coming back to pick it up. Maxwell and Roberts on the Minnesota defense. Eaves and Ciccarelli has it. Ciccarelli coming in. Drop back near the line. Maxwell keeping it in. Maxwell along the boards. Melrose bumped with him. Back to the net. Eaves trying to get loose. But Shand all over him. Shand holding Eaves in on the boards. Here comes Ciccarelli. And Eaves is belted right away by Melrose. And the Leafs hitting hard in their own zone as Preacher is allowed to come out. Preacher coming in. Is Anderson to the left side. Preacher carried in on the boards. And Shan going off. Bobby Smith is on the ice. Minnesota now on the power play. They're having difficulty, though, against Anderson's forechecking. Anderson trying to tie it up. And there's Bobby Smith. He's hit hard by Therrien. He's the penalty killer now with Gingron solving. Anderson is going off, so Billy Harris will be on. 2:35 left in the Leaf penalty to Jim Corn. It's 1-0 Toronto on the Therrien goal. Now coming in, Fleck. He's bumped by Therrien. Here comes Gingron. Bump in on the boards. Back to the line, Maxwell. Maxwell played it ahead. Smith looks back to Maxwell. Smith gives it to him. Maxwell winds up. Screen shot. Picked down in front. Payne went after it, but the Leafs will clear it off the boards. Down the ice.
Good play by Gingron. In front of that net, he held off a defender with one arm and got that puck out and down the ice.
No score in Buffalo. That's our update game tonight. Montreal is there, of course. We'll have highlights of that game for you. 1-0 here. Toronto leading. And they're shorthanded now. Getting it across the line is Gingras. He was given a jolt as he cleared that one out. 1:40 left in the penalty to Jim Corn. As Minnesota has to come back. Hartsburg flipped it to the line. And the Leafs doing a great job killing this penalty. Tell you, Mick, if they can kill this penalty, they'll get quite a lift. It'll be rattled down center ice.
So far, it's working out for them. 1:27 yet to go in the penalty to Corn.
That's Maxwell. Leafs forechecking. That was Martin. He has Gavin with him now up front, killing this penalty. Here's Hartsburg. His shot deflects off Melrose. Over the glass and into the crowd, and Corn now has a minute and 15 seconds to serve on his penalty.
We had that one afternoon game today in the National Hockey League. There you see the Islanders defeating Washington in Washington. So they get the home ice advantage back after losing one of the first two in Long Island. Warren with a pair, Trocchi with a pair, Tonelli and Nystrom for New York.
Jimmy Corn has 1:15 left in that penalty. McCarthy with Bellows to his right. And out on the left side is Ciccarelli. That's Salming again, getting rid of it to the line. Not out, though. Kept in. Broughton put it in front. Here's a chance for Ciccarelli. Down goes Palmatier. Went up high over the net, over the glass, and into the crowd.
Now, that's the Stars' first real good scoring chance with this man advantage, and little Dino Ciccarelli gets it. He's dangerous around the net. As they got the Leafs spread out in that four-man box, you see them all over the place, and there's Ciccarelli. From the side of the net, I think Therrien got a piece of it. That's what happened and deflected it up over the glass. Never did get to Palmatier.
So he scored one.
McCarthy heading for that open side.
And now he has helped to save one. Greg Therrien. 1-0 Toronto. McCarthy got the draw. That's Broughton at the line. Waited. Played it in to Bellows. Bellows in front of the net. Another shot. And Palmatier got a piece of that one. Bellows flipped it back to the net once again. Ciccarelli spinning around with it to get away from Salmi. To Bellows, and he's dangerous. Right in front. They missed the open side. That was McCarthy. He had the open net on the right side of Palmatier. Here's Bellows now. Can handle it. Bellows flipped it back to the net. Great pressure now by Minnesota. 35 seconds left in Corn's penalty. And that might do it. The Leafs shoot it down the ice.
Well, super play by Salmi to stop that pass coming out in front of McCarthy.
They shoot it in again, the Stars do. Like the icing. Jindrah catches that icing. Fouled against Minnesota. That's got to be frustrating.
Well, they had some great chances, Bob, in that last minute and a half. But the great defensive work by the Leafs, and Paul Mateer kept it out of there. It all but does it. Just 20 seconds left to number 20, Jim Korn's penalty. Rory Salming with a fine defensive play a moment ago. Watch Salming. Comes out from behind the net. This is just before Salming's great play. With McCarthy coming close on that opportunity.
Leafs have Jindrah. Parked up the blue line with Melrose. Gavin is up front with Martin. Korn has 20 seconds left in his penalty. Willie Plett out there for Minnesota. Steve Payne and Eves. Make that Bobby Smith with the draw. Plett on the right side. Went by Smith with the pass. Minnesota on the move. McAdam coming in. Took a drive away wide of the net off the boards to Max one up the blue line. He took a shot. Oh, Mateer, I don't know how he saw that one. It was deflected. He grabbed it and knocked it away. Martin on the boards. Korn is back on the ice. Minnesota keeping it in. And a penalty called at the far side. Interference call.
Going to go to Minnesota, I think, by the crowd reaction. Possibly the big man, Willie Plett. He was after it with Terry Martin and Melrose. Looks like Plett is going to the box.
This is Hockey Night in Canada from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto.
Good-looking dog.
I've really been working on this guy. I think he's got the potential to be a real good bird dog.
Looks real fast just lying there.
Come on, fetch, boy!
That's fast, Phil.
Keep on getting together. You keep on having your fun.
Hey, I said he had potential.
Why don't you train the cat?
Phil, that dog's dead.
You keep on drinking your ex, cause keeps on, keeps on, keeps on tasting great.
Here's a look at how this happened. Willie Plett right there, knocking Melrose down from behind. And he gets the call. The Leafs will get their first opportunity on the power play. So far in the series, the Leafs are 3-for-8 on the power play. And Minnesota, with their chance already here tonight, is 2-for-9 now.
And it's first period over in Buffalo. It's that 7 straight periods now. The Canadians have failed to score. There is no score in Buffalo. That's our update game tonight. And when the highlights become available, if there are any, see them. Here it's 1-0 for Toronto. And the Leafs now on a power play. 1:45 left in the penalty, an interference call against Plett. And Benning is coming in himself this time with Derlego. Divide in front of the net. They shoot at it. That was Derlego with a backhand shot. Now Benning tipped it from the goal post. Derlego has it. Benning hit the post with that shot. To the side of the net, Anderson. Now the Leafs whip it around. Salming shot right in front again. Comes back to Salming. He waits. Takes a look at Benning over in this side. Salming dancing this way now. Salming let it go. And that's stopped by Beaupre. Back of the net, Anderson. Vibe parked in front. Anderson can't make the play. Vibe with Derlego in the corner. Derlego stopping. Takes a look. Minnesota with a box set up. Into the corner to Anderson. Out to Salming, back to Anderson. There's the shot, and jumping on it is Don Beaupre, and he hangs on to it. 55 seconds left in the penalty to play it. Great puck control by the Maple Leafs, Mickey, but so far they have not been able to put a five Beaupre.
It was good control. Salming did a smart thing as well. He came off of the boards a couple of times, worked his way into the middle of the ice surface, and let his players converge in the front of the net. There's that one that went off of Maxwell's left skate, hit the goalpost behind Beaupre. Anderson just unable to handle the rebound. But Salming came off those boards and gets into the middle of the ice, has everybody heading for the front of the net. Beaupre made a couple of good saves on him.
Therrien now comes on for Toronto with Gary Lehman, number 16. Now he's parked just inside the blue line, just out of your picture. Here he comes now. Gary Lehman, he's an all-star from Regina. WHL. Just 19, Mickey, 5'11", 168.
First shift tonight.
Right behind is Adubny trying to get it back to Jindrah. Jindrah will handle it in the center ice area. Now then, here's Gary Lehman, 16. Feeds a pass over on the other side to Jindrah. He shoots it in. It comes crazy. boards this way. McCarthy for Minnesota flipped it ahead. Hartsburg gets across the line. 30 seconds left in the penalty to Plett of Minnesota. 1-0 is the score. Toronto leading. Libertarian goal. Now then, Lehman starting away. The youngster to center ice. Carries across center and shoots it in. Low play out of the net. Cover up for Giles, who tries to clear it. Stars will move it outside the blue line. The center ice. That's Ferguson coming in and ragging it. 5 seconds left in the Minnesota penalty. Now Plett is back on the ice. The penalty is over. And the Leafs lead 1-0 with Lehman coming to center. Scooping one in. Back forward quickly is Hartsburg. Comes to center ice again. Play settled down quite a bit now. They started in a rush. A lot of heavy hitting in the first 4 or 5 minutes. The Leafs got the only goal, and we got a penalty coming up. This is going to be against Minnesota. And that's it with a score. Toronto 1, Minnesota nothing. This is Stanley Cup 83.
The stands weren't exactly crowded when perhaps the most significant game in the long history of baseball was played. What made it so significant? Well, it certainly wasn't the baseball. No, it was the time of day, nightfall. For it was on this night in 1924 that a small group of General Electric engineers ushered in the era of night baseball and made possible for us all the many brilliant nights to come.
Plett may not have, as well, not have left the penalty box, Bob. He's only been out 18 seconds, and he finds himself back in again. And there is the reason. And that's a pretty good reason right there.
A high cross check by Plett. He's gone. So the Leafs, empty on the first power play, have another go at it. So they go with Anderson, Vive, Benning, and Salming. That's Eves to take the draw for Minnesota. Salming flicked his stick at it, but it's at the blue line, now over it into the center ice area. They pile in on it, but it comes loose right back to Benning. And he circles. Salming will lead the attack. Coming in, Derlego on the right side, five to the left. Minnesota lining up pretty well on that blue line. Anderson can't find any room. Trying to dig his way through, can't do it. McAdam gets it out to Eves. And he'll move it back down the ice. Look out for Eves. He's always dangerous, killing penalties. Took a shot in wide. He had 5 shorthanded goals in the regular season. Second to Wayne Gretzky. Back of the net. That's Anderson in the corner. Back to the blue line. Salming. Leafs on the power play. Up high to Gerlego behind the goal. He waited and was knocked to the ice. Now Vive in there bumping, trying to kick it loose. 1 minute left from the Minnesota penalty. The second one of the period to Willie Plett. Salming slapped at it. Couldn't get a shot. Now Anderson gets in position. Anderson to Benning. Shot. Knocked down in front. Anderson fanned on it. And the Minnesota North Stars shoot it down the ice. Both teams changing. 40 seconds left. And Plett's penalty. Gingras, Preacher, Dupney. Coming in with Therrien, stopped by Beaupre, and he flipped it aside for Giles. He lost it on the forechecking of Podubny. Now Therrien back to the line. Gingras shot, and that hit the goalpost on the outside. Grazed the post and went off to the corner. Gingras again, left it there. Leafs keep the pressure on. Therrien, he had the empty net, couldn't get a shot away. Now back of the net, 6 seconds left in the penalty. Therrien centered it. Scramble. Minnesota will clear it. They've killed another minor penalty to Willie Plett. Ferguson coming in. McAdam. And he couldn't hang on to the pass. McAdam centers it by Paul Mateer. And the Leafs. Podubny. He was bumped at center ice by Willie Plett. 3:50 left in the period. Leafs have to come back. 1-0. Maple Leafs out front as Korn shoots it down the ice. No icing. It's waved off. And coming back is Maxwell. Leafs change again. Korn at center ice stopped it. Bellows went after him. Korn flipped it over the line, though. Now Korn gone to the Leaf bench, and he's heading off to the Leaf dressing room. Jimmy Korn. 3:24 left in this first period. The Leafs leading 1-0. There's a play to center ice to Roberts. Flipped it into Bellows. Back quickly is Lehman. Gary Lehman, number 16, got a pass over the right side. Not a bad play to center ice it comes. Bellows and Bellows pushing in behind the play. The referee, Andy Van Helleman, watching that closely. Leafs keep it in. Boudreaux got in front, couldn't get a stick on it. 3 minutes left in the period. Bellows running into Lehman at the blue line. Here comes Boudreaux. Just skated by the puck. And Eves starts back out. Eves to center, plays it in. Paul Mateer out of the net, but it's grabbed by Börje Salming. To Martin. Martin coming out. Leaves it for Lehman. He lost it. Got away from Giles' check. Now Bobby Smith coming in. Smith passed it back in front of Hartsburg. And a shot. Ooh, beautiful save by Mike Paul Mateer. And we're getting another penalty on the play.
Well, I think it's Toronto going to go this time. But what a stop by Paul Mateer on Hartsburg. The first one and the rebound. Leafs will be shorthanded.
Hockey Night in Canada will continue in a moment.
Why don't you just buy her some perfume?
No, it's not good enough.
Well, you know what you could do?
You could get her one of those little purses that sits on the hip and has the,
Oh, yeah, I've seen it.
Hey, wait a second. What about one of those big purses?
You keep on getting together. You keep on having your fun.
Why don't you get her a dishwasher?
She's already got one.
Let's think a little while.
Keep on drinking your ex, cause keeps on, keeps on, keeps on tasting great.
Frankie Nigro gets the box for the Leafs. Bobby Smith setting up Hartsburg. And look at these two chances. Good save by Palmateer there. And Hartsburg unable to get it up over top. And there you see Nigro knocking the Minnesota player in behind Palmateer. That's the reason for his penalty. And the Stars will go on the power play.
And Bobby Smith, number 15, dangerous shooter for Minnesota, scoring big goals in the first two games. McCarthy with him. Gets it in front. But there's Gavin with Therrien, a penalty killer. Shand is back on the defense with Melrose. McCarthy back there for Minnesota. Willie Platt on the right wing. And they're starting out as Bobby Smith comes in behind Broughton. Broughton carrying the puck. Leaves it for Smith. A neat play. Smith gets it back to the line. Broughton gets it now. Broughton played it in to McCarthy. McCarthy back to the net. McCarthy waits for that return pass from Smith. Here it comes in front. All the way back to Broughton. Long shot, just wide as Hartsburg let it go. McCarthy now, Minnesota to the power play in control. McCarthy in a step or two. Back to Broughton, he missed it. Gavin hustling back now to give Broughton some trouble. Caught up to him, but Hartsburg has the puck. McCarthy stopped near center by Harris. A minute left in the penalty. Nigro of Toronto on the lead, shoot it down in.
Minnesota with some great control on that power play, but Leafs are doing a good job of playing the four-man box and keeping them outside, out of range.
45 seconds left. Nigro penalty. Bobby Smith again. Fans on him now. Smith dropped it back to Maxwell. Shot deflected. Wait to Paul Mateerlo. And he got a piece of it, and the Leafs shoot it out and down the ice again. 55 seconds left in the period. 30 seconds in the penalty to Nigro. The Leafs leading. Just 1-0, though. Therrien has the goal, and here's Lego. Into the shot. Good save by Beaupre. Under Lego, and he's been really firing in these first three games, Bill DeLego. He has one goal to show for it. Paul Mateer tipped one away, hustles back to the net, though. There's a quick shot. Paul Mateer was back just in time, let me tell you. 5 seconds left in the penalty. And the Leafs have killed it now. Nigro is ready to come back on. Here's DeLego coming in with him. Shot. Right on. That's stopped by Beaupre. Live from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto, the Stanley Cup playoffs.
I can see it.
Bronze.
I can feel it now.
Ultra thin foil, platinum coated, smooth and close, and only Bronze has it. If you don't believe there's a difference, shave with your rotary. Then shave right away with Bronze. You can hear Bronze cutting the stubble you left behind.
I can hear it.
You can sense the Bronze difference.
Bronze.
Now, with up to $10 back, you can sense the value, too.
Well, it's been rough in this first period, and the Leafs have come up with the only scoring play. The goaltenders have been sharp.
Beaupre was pretty sharp on that one, as he gave Clive a pretty good whack in the head. Told Rob Jimmy Corn there's a bruise in his right leg. We're not sure of his status, whether he'll be back or not. We'll have to get an update of that whenever we can. We'll pass it on.
There's Vibe coming in, can't get a shot. Solving Mike, there it is, caught by Beaupre. And only 12 seconds left in the period, and the Leafs controlled the play right on that faceoff. Rick Vibe has been more physical in this game than he has in the first two.
Sure has. So he's taking a pretty good beating, too, from the North Stars. They're on him all the time. When you score that many goals, you've got to expect that kind of attention. What a rugged first period of hockey.
Only 12 seconds to play in the period now. And Shingraw comes off the Leaf bench. Will relieve Shan. Dave Shan, number four, going off. There's Derlego with Anderson to his left. Five right behind him. 12 seconds to play in the period. 1-0 Toronto. North Stars control on the draw. 10 seconds left. They'll try to kill the clock back there. That's Roberts. He's doing a pretty good job of it. Leafs go line. It's over now. With 1 second showing, and the horn goes to end the first period. The shots were by Toronto 12 and by Minnesota 9. Coming up next, Leaf center Greg Therrien, as he spoke with Dave Hodge just before tonight's game. So the score at the end of the first period is Toronto 1 and Minnesota nothing.
Ford Escort, success car for very good reasons. Escort has nimble front-wheel drive, four-wheel independent suspension, and great fuel economy. No wonder Escort sales are jumping over most big cars, small cars, foreign cars, domestic cars, over cars of all shapes and prices. As time goes by, Canada's weather can prey on your house and your house paint. The sun fades it. The heat peels it. The cold cracks it. The wetness rots it. Your defense? Canadian Tire Paints. Now formulated to help stop the effects of Canada's weather. So the next time you paint, remember Canadian Tire's full line of indoor and outdoor paints. Because only the strong survive.
It's an excitement you can taste. Rich, colorful, refreshingly white, cool, and creamy smooth as the land it comes from. It's the Dairy Queen Banana Split. Come taste the excitement.
In the land of Dairy Queen, we treat you right.
You don't have to put up with hotel excuses like the maid, the TV man, or the plumber is gone for the day, because Holiday Inn gives you this no-excuses guarantee in writing. Everything in your room will be right, or we'll make it right. No excuses, or that night you stay free. Now, what other hotel chain gives you that guarantee? So, let us take care of you. Holiday Inn gives you a guarantee, not excuses.
The Challenger. How is the government's billion-dollar baby?
The Buffalo's going to come back before you get that money back.
The Fifth Estate, Wednesday.
Half a dozen Toronto Maple Leafs carried a tremendous workload in the first two games of this series at Bloomington, Minnesota, and one of them was center Greg Therrien. The Leafs undermanned because of injuries. How did you react, first of all, to all the ice time that you did receive?
Well, it's a little different, you know. I'm not saying that I wasn't out of shape, but, you know, when you get a little bit more ice time, you know, at the end of the third period there, you're sure to feel a little bit more than when you're, you know, getting two or three shifts, or now you're getting five or six shifts, and mostly now the stress of playing in the playoffs, you can sort of feel it a little bit.
Is fatigue then a factor the longer this series goes for you and a few other Leafs?
I think that, you know, we're in good shape, but, you know, it's going to have a little bit of a damper on the pace of a game at the end of the third period. You know, it has a tendency to show a little bit.
Bobby Smith has been the hero for the Minnesota North Stars, and you've seen a lot of him over the course of the regular season and in the playoffs, though it should be mentioned that you were not against him when he scored the two big goals in game number two. What do you do to try to prevent a big man like that from dominating someone who is smaller?
You know, Bobby's been just playing great, and he's really good with the puck, and like he's got those long arms. And what you try to do is just try to get close to him and don't give him that room to get wound up. Like, he makes that big circle, and then he gets that puck, you know, and his body's on one side and the puck's on the other, but he still has control. And you just have to keep bumping him and frustrating him. That's about the only thing you can do. But, you know, he's been playing great, and hopefully it'll change around tonight.
No matter whom you check against the North Stars, you've got two new line mates on your own side. Has that been a big adjustment to try to play with Podubny and Freecher, whom you're not used to?
Yeah, well, the first game I found it was a little bit more difficult, but then the second game I found that it seemed to be going a little bit more smoother, and I think just a matter of the more you play with somebody, the more you get to know their speed compared to the other line. There's just different speeds in that, but, you know, they've been playing well, and what I'm going to try to do is just get the puck to those two and let them do their thing, and I'll just try to get in the holes.
Are you trying to stress offense more than you would have been on your line with Martin and Harris?
Oh, definitely. I think, you know, that without that line of Freecher and Podubny, you got to take a little bit more offense for sure.
Well, you thought offense against Minnesota, scored 5 goals in the regular season against them, and that's more than any other Leaf. You'd like to start popping a few to make this series a longer one, right?
Yeah, it sure would be nice to get 5 tonight, but yeah, it would be nice to get a couple goals for sure.
It's been great to watch the Leafs extend themselves physically, those who have had all the ice time, and Greg Therrien is one so far in this series. We'll continue with Hockey Night in Canada in the Stanley Cup playoffs in just a moment.
Seiko LaSalle, marvels of thinness. So perfected, so refined, they reach the realm of art. Seiko LaSalle, thin, rich, beautiful. Only the highest quartz technology could create such extraordinary design, achieve such flawless performance. Seiko LaSalle, no wonder people trust Seiko more than any other watch.
Up until now, there's only been the two of you, and you pretty much take care of one another. But now, there's a new person in your lives, a new responsibility. We have the protective instinct, too, about life and security and the future. And that's what life insurance is all about.
Life is a mutual affair.
Talk it over with your Mutual Life of Canada agent.
Last month, the boss gave me a new job. Cooper? I want you to choose the office copier. So I looked at everyone there was, every single one. How's it coming, Cooper? Finally, I chose a Xerox copier. The price was right, the copies were superb, and the selection was miles ahead. But most importantly, it's got Xerox behind it.
Good choice, Cooper. Now then.
After all, nobody ever went wrong being fussy and stingy.
Thinking of buying a VCR?
Compare and save with Sanyo.
Compare oranges with oranges. Compare Sanyo's basic model with other basic models. Compare Sanyo's top of the line with equivalent models of other brands.
Compare and save with Sanyo.
It's the same story virtually every time. You save money with Sanyo.
Compare and save with Sanyo. Because Sanyo makes life good things better.
When the Buffalo Sabres shut out the Canadiens 1-0 right in the Forum in Montreal in Game 1 of their series, people said it was a shocker. Well, make it read double shocker, because after Game 2, the Canadiens still had not scored a goal and left the ice at the end of regulation time on the brink of elimination from the Stanley Cup playoffs. The Sabres in total command of the hockey game, and they were 3-0 winners. Unlike Game 1, that was scoreless going into the last period and really anybody's game, the Sabres took control right off the bat, and they scored very early in the hockey game to really establish the pattern. The play was deep in the Montreal zone, and Rick Seeling along the boards, working on Larry Robinson, gets the puck to Gilbert Perreault. And Perreault makes a perfect pass to Dale McCord, who was left uncovered in front of Rick Walmsley, and the Sabres have a 1-0 lead. In the first period, the Canadiens managed just one shot on goal. Then Buffalo came up with 2 quick goals in the second period. They were on a power play with Pierre Mondeau in the penalty box, and rookie Phil Housley feeds Gilles Amel on the right wing, and he drills one past Walmsley. It's 2-0 Buffalo at 6:03. And then came a big play in the hockey game less than 30 seconds later, as deep in his own zone, Mike Ramsey of the Sabres picks up the puck. Now you'll see a terrific collision between Ramsey and the Canadiens goaltender Walmsley, as Ramsey works against Montreal rookie defenseman Rick Natras. He slides into the goal crease, hits Walmsley, who's out of position, and Mel Davis comes in and scores the third goal of the game. That was it. The Sabres control things from then on. Robert Sobe with two straight shutouts at the Forum in Montreal, and Buffalo leads the series 2-0. This is Dick Irvin reporting.
The story in Game 2 of the Calgary-Vancouver series, as far as the Canucks were concerned, was once again the outstanding play of their netminder Richard Brodeur. But the Canucks are learning very quickly that they cannot do it all with Brodeur. They have got to get some goal scoring. The Flames broke it wide open with a couple of quick goals in the third period. Lanny McDonald taking a perfect pass from Kevin Lavallee and then beating Brodeur with a hard shot from the right side. That was McDonald's second goal of the game. Jim Jackson made it 4-1 Calgary in the third period, and it was simply perseverance paying off for the youngster right here. He finally gains control of a bouncing puck right there and then flips it over Brodeur to make it 4-1, and that pretty well wrapped it up for the Flames. Roger Nielsen pulled Brodeur with 3 minutes to play in the final period. And it's netminder Reggie Lemelin who comes closest to scoring. Look how close Lemelin comes to making NHL history. But the Flames go on to beat Vancouver 5-3. Calgary take a 2-0 lead heading to Vancouver. With the Flames and Canucks in Calgary, I'm Steve Arman.
Game 2, a completely different story in the Jets-Oilers showdown in Edmonton. The Jets check the Oilers at every turn before losing 4-3 in the final moments of Period 3. The Jets have reason to be a little bit upset, angry about a third period goal credited to the Oilers. Here you'll see it, Paul Coffey the shot. It looks like it goes off the post, but the goal judge ruled it a goal and the referee let it count. Now you'll see it from a different angle, and this is what the goal judge saw. He called it a goal, the Oilers out in front of the Jets by one at that stage of the game. However, the Jets come right back. In the third period, 3:26, Dale Hawerchuk for Mo Mantha once more. Mantha, his second of the night. It's all even at three once more. The Oilers had never had the lead in the hockey game until this moment. 18:16, final period. The power finally came to the fore. Lindsman dropping it back for Mark Messier. Messier counts his second of the night. The Oilers onto a 4-3 victory and a 2-0 series lead. This is John Wells reporting on the Jets and the Oilers.
Six of the eight first-round series have the potential to conclude tonight. As yet, though, the only possible series winner that is leading tonight is Edmonton. We'll give you some updates on the other series, specifically Montreal and Buffalo, which remain scoreless as we return with the Stanley Cup playoffs in just a moment.
You want to break a world record. You need coaches, training, competition. So we're funding SO Swim Canada, supporting swim clubs, encouraging skills. Now good swimmers can get better. Maybe the world's best. Canada. Coming through for you makes us better too.
You make us better, you do. SO.
The new Thunderbird is about performance. You ask, it answers. Acceleration, handling, braking. You demand, Thunderbird responds as if it were a part of you. The essence is performance. Thunderbird for 1983. We said we'd make it exciting, and we did. Have you driven a Ford lately?
Great beer tradition comes a great new beer. Introducing Export Light. With a distinctive light taste that's earned the name Export. a great tradition has come to light. Discover the taste of export lights.
The nominees for Best Television Program of the Year. The winner, Saturday.
The Montreal Canadiens have been shut out for seven consecutive periods and part of an eighth by Bob Sauvé and the Buffalo Sabres. They are on a power play now, though, midway through the second period. As the game is scoreless in Buffalo, we go to Danny Gallivan and Don Cherry.
We welcome the viewers who have been watching the game between the Toronto Maple Leafs and the Minnesota North Stars. I'm Dick Irvin here in Buffalo with Danny Gallivan and Don Cherry. There is no score in the game between the Canadiens and the Sabres. Montreal on a power play right here, and Steve Shutt of the Canadiens has just had two great scoring chances. The first a moment ago on a big shot from left wing, and then Robert Sauvé, who has blanked the Canadiens throughout this series, came up very big right there on Shutt. Some pushing and shoving after that, no damage done.
Bob Perry, stay with this power play. He's loaded up. This is it. If he's going to score, this is the best five guys he could put out.
Minute and 35 seconds left in the penalty. The Canadiens have had two good scoring opportunities in the first 20 seconds on this penalty, Don. Now they're going to try it again. Lafleur ahead to Robinson, the big bird into the center ice area. Shutt goes after the pass. Here's Shutt coming in, trying to shake off height, and it's picked up by Peterson. Peterson shooting it down the ice. The fans in Buffalo deeply appreciative of the defensive work of this team in the playoffs, and they applaud every time they break up the Canadiens' power play attempt. Now Robinson up on the right side to Lafleur. Over goes to Trombley. Trombley to Naslund, and Shutt. He scores! Naslund!
What they needed.
Now for Robert Sauvé, his scoreless string ends at 147 minutes and 25 seconds. And the Canadiens, for the first time in this series, score and take the lead.
Looks like it was tipped in. Sauvé would have had that one. Mike Ramsey, it looked like it hit a stick. Went in. Let's see if it does. Lays the stick on the ice. All you young defensemen, leave it alone. 24.
Well, standing ovation, Dick, for Sauvé.
Well, well deserved, too.
Here's Bill Hyatt's stick.
Well, Frank McCool's playoff record of three consecutive shutouts will not be equaled by Bob Sauvé in this Montreal-Buffalo series. The Canadiens have finally scored. Montreal 1 and Buffalo nothing. The score is 1-0 for the home side here at Maple Leaf Gardens. Greg Therrien scoring his first goal of this series, his second career playoff goal. He had one as a Los Angeles King. Now let's go for the second period to Bob Cole and Mickey Redmond.
Thank you, Dave. Well,
Mickey Redmond.
Thank you, Dave. Well, Mickey, the drought is over to this point for the Montreal Canadiens. They finally got a goal against Buffalo in that series. And here, just one goal has been scored as we get ready to start the second period. That one, as Dave said, by Therrien, his first. It's 6:49 of the opening period, and the shots, you see them. 12-9, Toronto Maple Leafs. And a rough first half of the first period, but they seem to settle down a bit after that. And I detected once or twice during the period, Mickey, the two teams appeared to be a little bit on the nervous side. Bad passing, shaky.
They certainly did. They're a little apprehensive on both sides. Big Jim Korn is back out on the ice right now. He's heading for the Toronto bench. He looks like he's all right. Receiving that bruised knee on a check by McAdam in the first period. Both teams had their scoring chances.
We're told that Jim Korn has suffered a Charlie horse. So they'll ice that down every chance they get. Get it better and win this game and go on to bigger things maybe. Tomorrow night, that's the schedule for a fourth game, should there be one, at 7 o'clock tomorrow night Eastern Time. But right now, Minnesota leading the series 2-0, and trailing the Leafs 1-0 in this one. On the move, stop quickly. That was Bellows who tried to break through. On the Maple Leafs with Freacher, Therrien, and Podubny again. Long shot by Maxwell, tipped away by Paul Mateer. There's Bellows, he's on with Payne and Eaves. Eaves missed the pass in the corner. Eames went after. Salmingo brings it out with Podubny. Going in with a shot, right on, and Beaupre stopped that. Creature upended behind the play. Creature couldn't knock that one down. Melrose is going back. Shand is on the defense with Melrose now. For Toronto and Minnesota making changes. Melrose nearly miscued. Therrien comes back to cover up. Bobby Smith after him. Paul McTeer was bumped and the puck went over the glass into the crowd.
Here once again, some out of town scores at final this afternoon in Washington. The Nordiques trying to get back in the series ahead of the Boston Bruins. And 1-1 in Winnipeg, Edmonton. Coffey, assisted by Gretzky over there, and he's nothing in Vancouver. And a big game in St. Louis tonight. Philadelphia Rangers, that was a 9 o'clock start Eastern time due to the circus in Madison Square Garden.
Every playoff year, you have the circus. Wouldn't be the same for the New York Rangers without a circus in town.
You know what's in there, I'll tell you.
Want to explain yourself?
You could smell it for miles away. Madison Square Garden is quite a complex. Of course, the rink is, on the fifth floor of that building. Amazing. A bowling alley underneath.
Hall of Fame. Railway station in the basement.
Got it all.
He got it all. The Big Apple. 1:14 gone in the second period. 1-0. Toronto. Giles. Grab. Rebound. That was close. Plett tried to tuck it in behind Paul Mateer. Now it comes back to Giles again. Another shot. Hit the goal post. It was tipped and hit the net on the outside. Just outside the post. Giles hit the blue line again. Giles flipped it on the boards. Minnesota with the pressure on now. In front of the net is Melrose to pick it up. Coming out. Long pass to Harris. Center Harris. He's bumped by Giles. Giles going to the ice on that check. McAdam coming out. Dropped it back. McAdam is taken in on the boards over there by Martin. Hartsburg brings it in. Left it there for Plett. He's bumped by Shand lightly. Melrose shoots it up behind the net. Paul Mateer out of the goal. Look out. Here comes Priest throwing a check. Giles coming in. A penalty coming up against Minnesota.
Oh.
Referee Andy Van Halleman went down. And Priest over to argue a bit. Ooh. He fell right on him.
Well, he was...
The Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. This is Stanley Cup 83 on CBC.
This is the 1983 Lawnboy Supreme, powered by an engine designed to last 50% longer than most other lawnmower engines. This Lawnboy can do the work of five lawnmowers. It cuts, side bags, rear bags, mulches. It'll even shred leaves. Summer after summer, year after year. The hardworking 5-in-1 lawnmower by Lawn Boy. Lawn Boy, as time goes by, you'll know why.
Well, there's Andy Van Helleman just making his way to the timer's bench now to make the call, as Ron Friest is definitely getting at least 2 minutes. As Andy Van Helleman took a dangerous spill. Watch this. The old BC two-hander by Ronnie Friest right there. Ouch. And then he went to go after Andy Van Helleman. Andy fell down, and look what we got now. A bench penalty is coming up. Minnesota. Boy, oh boy, this is going to hurt the North Stars.
Andy Van Helleman, Mickey, was hit to the ice and appeared to be injured, and the North Stars are all over him now.
And it's Bobby Smith who was doing the jawing over off the Minnesota bench. And what a situation we've got now. A full 2 minutes. Of a 5-on-3. Lou Nanny, very incensed. Here's where Friest is going to go after. Look how it ends up. Andy goes down and runs underneath Friest. It really was unintentional, but he may have even gotten an extra two. He was going after Van Helleman. And right there where you see Andy Van Helleman, he took up his position. The jawing started off the Minnesota bench. And take it away, Bob.
Well, the Leafs have an opportunity to take it away now, Mickey, with a two-man advantage. Anderson going in with Derlego in front of the net. The Stars break it up, and the Leafs will have to come back and start it again. 1:40 left in the penalties now. Smith and Priest are in the penalty box. Coming out is Benning. Benning with five. Anderson, Derlego, and Salming. They're having trouble. Salming wants the puck, so Benning gives it to him. Lost it. Benning again. Leafs unable to play it in. Maybe they should revert to shooting it in and pour it after it. They got two extra skaters out there. DeLego falls. Where is it? Eaves goes over. Now Vive has it. Maxwell without a stick. Roberts trying to hook it away. Roberts in on the boards. Puck grab there. He might fall on it. He does. And they get a whistle. That's just what Minnesota wanted with a minute left in the penalties. They're doing a pretty good job.
Well, Minnesota really keeping the Leafs at bay. They were all standing still for a few moments, Bob. That was the problem. You tried to figure out why they couldn't get over that blue line. They had no speed whatsoever. And the Minnesota team was just standing up at the blue line and turning them away. Talk about injuries and referees being hurt this year. We understand Wally Harris has been hurt in Buffalo, but he is now back in action. And we're going to get a look at it here to see a couple of the combatants go at it. DeLorme for Canadians. I can't see who the Buffalo player is, but Harris was injured, but now back in the play again.
Giles will clear it out for Minnesota. Gingras is back for it. Hadubny with Preacher and Therrien, the line on there for Toronto now, solving the other man. Here he is, playing it in on a skate. Hadubny walks into the corner, back to solving. This looks like a pretty good setup. It goes to Preacher, to Gingras, got the big shot, raised the goalpost. Preacher again into the corner. Preacher taking his time. Gingras to Preacher. Preacher to Solving. 24 seconds left in the penalties at 2-on-1 Minnesota. Ferguson going in, and he whistled it wide. Now the Leafs have a 3-on-1. Here they come. Down to center is Podubny with Therrien. Podubny's shot right on the net. Beaupre stopped it. Rebound, and Beaupre grabbed it before Therrien could get his stick on it to put it behind him. Wow. 7 seconds left in the penalties.
Boy, the Leafs very frustrated on this play. Salming could not handle the puck. This is the ensuing action as Donnie Beaupre covers it up, but Salming took a perfect pass to the right of Beaupre of the open net, could not handle the puck. And be darned if the North Stars don't tie this hockey game on a 2-on-1. George Ferguson whistling one just wide of the big side, to the large side of the net as Palmateer came out.
Big faceoff now to the left of Beaupre. 7 seconds left on the penalties. The Leafs will try to get the draw back to Gingras. He's just inside the blue line. Therrien waved out. In comes Podubny. And now they're ready to go. Christensen drops it in. Roberts controlling for Minnesota. The Stars, Eaves trying to move it up. Now the penalties are over. Here goes Bobby Smith after it. Right out of the box. And Palmateer whipped it away. Eaves at center. Stopped by Therrien. Eaves again picking it up. Eaves going in, he's knocked out, a penalty coming up against the Toronto Maple Leafs. I think it's Borja Salming. Full goal. Tonight's Stanley Cup playoff game is coming to you from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto.
If we were doing drugs, we probably wouldn't perform like this. Believe me, we all have a choice.
This has been a public service announcement presented by the RCMP.
There's Borja Salming in the penalty box, a hooking call against Salming.
Well, there it is, Bob, right there, that stick up very dangerously to the facial area of Mike Eaves, and once again the North Stars will get their pop at the power play.
Rotten at the blue line with Hartsburg. That's Hartsburg getting the shot. Deflected away. Bobby Smith to Hartsburg. Another go at it. That missed. At the blue line, Rotten coming in. Takes a look over there to Hartsburg. Goes to the far side. All the care blocked that shot from Bobby Smith. Smith again controlling for Minnesota. Dropping it out, Hartsburg, another shot, tipped by Smith high over the glass.
Look at the action in front of Palmateer. Willie Plett is just everywhere. He's got both defensemen paying attention to him. Paul Mateer can't see anything, but the big man, 6'3", 210 pounds, is parked in front of him. And the North Stars are just taking shooting practice. Look at Platt in there. There's no way that Paul Mateer can see anything until they moved away, and he just got a piece of it.
Smith touched it, then Paul Mateer, and then it went over the glass, hence the faceoff to the left of the Toronto goal. Coming up to the five-minute mark of the second period, 1-0 Toronto. Our update game tonight is from Buffalo. The Canadians are leading there 1-0. Finally getting a goal against the Buffalo Sabres. Trying to stave off elimination. Sabres lead the series 2-0. Minnesota this one, 2-0. Toronto in this third game, 1-0. Terry on the goal in the first period. At 6:49, unassisted. Willie Platt in to take the draw. Leafs get it though. Payne went after it. Comes to Broughton near the line. Broughton played it in for Platt and Smith. Minute 20 left in the penalty to Salming. Long shot, tipped away from the net. Hit Platt, I believe, and missed the net. They keep it in. Down goes Paul Mateer. And Kirion happens to be right on the spot to clear it over the glass into the crowd as Paul Mateer made two saves. One, though, Mickey, looked like a dangerous rebound, but Greg Therrien was there.
Well, Platt could not get the first rebound up over top. Here you see Platt again going for the net, tried to deflect it, couldn't. Got the rebound, jammed it into the pads. And fortunately, as you mentioned, Therrien was there instead of one of those three North Stars to jam it in the open net.
So a minute and 8 seconds left of the penalty to Salming. This period, the highlight so far, penalty killing. The Leafs had a two-man advantage and couldn't score. Now Hartsburg on a power play for Minnesota to Maxwell. Into the side, that goes to McCarthy, back of the net. Cleared back out to the line, Hartsburg ready. Cicerelli in front, tipped it. And it went up over the net. Back of the goal is Cicerelli. Watch him, he's tricky. Back to Maxwell, he scores! Maxwell fired the shot. Might have hit something in front. And it popped the far corner, a power play goal for Minnesota. And they're back in it, 1-1.
Well, that puck definitely did hit something, Bob. It may have been the Leaf defenseman. Shan was dumped in front of the net right there. Cicerelli starting this out back to Maxwell. Look at that. It hit
Minnesota
Barry Melrose. Barry Melrose standing right in front of Paul Mateer. And it seemed to hit him between the pads and go underneath. There's a shot by Bellows, or the deflection by Bellows that almost went in. And there comes the goal. See that? It hits Melrose in the knees and bounces down underneath Paul Mateer, and we're tied.
5:35, the time of the goal. Cicerelli and Hartsburg assisted. The second for Maxwell in the series. So the score is tied at 1. Minnesota getting a power play goal. Now Giles, the pass to center ice. Coming in on the wing. Minnesota on the move now. That was Mandich trying to shoot it in. He got it off the boards. And Paul Mateer, not taking any chances now, smothers this one. Hangs on to it. This is Hockey Night in Canada from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto.
Okay, move them out!
If you've got goods to deliver and your trucks don't seem to care, if your peak season comes and your trucks are past their peak, then it's Ryder to the rescue. Ryder rents trucks. From small vans up to giant tractors to move your products or your family.
Ain't they beautiful?
When your trucks are giving up, Ryder trucks are just starting up.
Face off now to the left of Paul Mateer. Boudreau on for the Maple Leafs with Martin and Harris. That's Ferguson, number 21, moving in at center ice for Minnesota as Friis to his left. It's cleared back down the ice. And Minnesota coming back. Al McAdam on the right wing on that Minnesota line. As the Stars bring it out now. The score is tied here in the second. They've got one apiece. There's McAdam, couldn't reach it. Giles starts it again. Harris watching him. Priest on the boards. Ferguson picking it up and coming in for Minnesota. Ferguson in on the far side around Martin, centering it, went through the crease. Paul Mateer down, Giles is shot, hit a leg, and bodies are flying everywhere. Salming has just picked up another penalty for cross-checking.
with a score, Minnesota 1, Toronto 1. This is Stanley Cup 83.
McDonald's presents the 99-cent Egg McMuffin sale. A terrific deal.
Imagine, only 99 cents for an Egg McMuffin.
There's a fresh Canada Grade A large egg.
Grilled in butter.
Back bacon and mild processed cheddar cheese.
All tucked into a toasty English muffin.
And only 99 cents.
Now that's one terrific deal.
The 99-cent Egg McMuffin sale at McDonald's. But just until May 1st.
Imagine only 99 cents for an Egg McMuffin.
Salming has gone again. That's his second penalty of this period. This one for cross-checking. And again, Minnesota's power play. Broughton's pass, a shot by Hertzberg is blocked. Fired down the ice by the Maple Leafs. Jim Korn and Charlie Horace sitting on the Leaf bench. He has not been on the ice in this second period.
He has not, Bob, and if he cannot continue, they're going to miss him.
This is Broughton doing some fancy work. Played it into one side for Plett. Back it comes to Hartsburg. Again, Hartsburg from the blue line. There's the shot. Wait at Paul Mateer. Now Steve Payne getting in front. Shoots. Paul Mateer stopped it. Took his time, smothered it, and held on. Score tied at one.
Here's a look at the big man, Jimmy Korn, back in behind the Toronto bench right now. Pained expression on his face. You know he wants to be out there. Well, Minnesota really controls the puck well on the power play. They've had it the last power play until they finally scored. Complete control in the Leafs zone. And they're doing it again here.
Score tied at one, and Bobby Smith comes to center. He has Payne on the left wing. Try to get it over there. Couldn't quite do it. Plett playing the right side. Goes in back of the net. Forcing Gingras up on the boards. Payne again. Left it there. Now he gets it back to the line to Hartsburg. Screen shot. Knocked down in front of the net. And the Leafs tip it out. That was Therrien who tipped it to center ice. In the penalty. 1 minute left. Salming is off for cross-checking. Ball of a tier out of the net to stop it. Melrose hammered at it. Went high over the glass into the crowd. And we'll get a face-off at the lead zone. We're tied here at one, nearing the eight-minute mark, and during our intermission, Rick Vi was presented with the Molson Cup from Anders Kullegren, Vice President of Marketing for Ontario. Now Molson's, there's Rick. Mickey had 75 points in the three-star selections throughout the season, and he was number one here in Toronto.
Well, he had another great year, and of course, second only to Anderson. On the team scoring with 79 points, another 50-goal year.
Roberts at the line. Now McCarthy, that's kicked out by Paul Mateer. Big save by Mike Paul Mateer. Bellows couldn't center it. It's tipped away by Gingras. 33 seconds left in Salming's penalty. The score tied at one. Minnesota trying to take the lead here on a power play. A pass down to the right side, stopped by Dave Shand. Offside is Ciccarelli. There's one of the fill-ins the Maple Leafs have had to call up, and he has filled in admirably, Dave Shand.
Well, he had a good year down in St. Catharines. Not an offensive defenseman. He did have 9 goals down there and 31 assists for 40 points. 149 minutes in penalties. Dave from Cold Lake, Alberta. Long way from Toronto, Ontario.
20 seconds left on Salming's penalty. The North Star Ciccarelli belted by Melrose. And again, the puck over the glass. Billy Ooh. Harris reaching for it.
Well, here's a guy. Just ruined a $50 outfit for a $2 puck. Almost broke his neck in the process. I hope he got it. Pretty good header.
Harris again, bearing it for Toronto. That might do it. Salming standing up at the penalty bench. He has 5 seconds left. And Minnesota starting out. Salming is on the ice. They get it in front of the net. Great save by Beaupre. Martin and Harris coming close just as Salming stepped on the ice. Now
back in is Ciccarelli. At the blue line, Ciccarelli passed it over in front. Bellows was covered in front of the net by Stalding. At the 9-minute mark of the second period. Starting to pick up a bit now. More hitting. Melrose just slammed Ciccarelli again. Now Ciccarelli against Melrose. Ciccarelli shot blocked by Melrose. And the lead's back. Vine coming down with Anderson. Martin going on. Long shot. Lego is on the ice. And Beaupre taking no chances with Big Vine cruising in.
Now Melrose injured on that play. That slap shot by Ciccarelli. He went down, blocked the shot. But it looked like it caught him just above the knee where there's very little padding. And he's in pain on the Leaf bench. Watch Melrose go down here now. Just as Ciccarelli let the shot go. Right there. Caught him on that right knee. They hurt.
Derligo, Anderson, Vine, Ferguson at center ice for Minnesota. And I think Derligo and Ferguson have been waved out. McAdam, 25, comes in. They drop it in, and it comes all the way down the ice. Nearing the halfway mark of the second period. Score tied at one. There's Priest. Backhands it in for Minnesota. Paul Mateer setting it up near the blue line. Anderson can't get going. He has to go back with it. Now they move it up. This is Derligo with Vive and Anderson. Vive cutting in. Tried to make that move right in front of Cup. There's going to be a penalty on the play. Derligo was dumped. Hockey night in Canada will continue in a moment.
Out of a great beer tradition comes new Export Light. With a distinctive light taste that's earned the name Export. A great tradition has come to light. Discover the taste of Export Light.
Well, Dan Mandich in the box for Minnesota. And that all set up as it looked like Derligo was hauled down in front of Beaupre as Vive, Derligo, and Anderson made a rush towards the net. And there it is right there, Billy D. Being hauled down by Mandich. And now the Leafs will get their pop on the power play. There's been two straight North Star power plays.
Score tied at one. Derligo, Vive, Anderson, Gingras, Salming. That's the power play for Toronto. Again, Derligo waved out. McAdam comes in against Anderson. Eves is number 18, a penalty killer for Minnesota. At the line, Gingras waits for it. Gets his shot away. A lot of mustard on it. Gingras can shoot them a lot harder than that. He didn't get too much on it, but it looked tricky for Beaupre.
It was a bad choice of shots there, Bob. Salming, just trying to keep the puck in, was being forced out by Eves. And he's just trying to get control. Shot it a little bit too hard over there. Gingras decided to let it go at the net. I don't think he got full wood on it. But that's the reason Minnesota's been successful. And there we have another update out of Boston, or out of Quebec, I should say. The Colisée, the Nordiques, hanging in there, 2-1. And they could go out tonight if they don't win that hockey game.
Vive picking it up, dropping it behind the net. Roberts has his man tied up. The North Stars will clear it down the ice. A minute and a half left of the penalty to Mandich. The score tied at one here in the second. Our update game tonight is from Buffalo. The Canadians are there trying to stave off elimination against the Buffalo Sabres. Here the Leafs trying to get back into this series. Minnesota leading 2-0. And at the moment the teams are in a deadlock at one. Mandich in the penalty. 1 minute, 5 seconds left. Anderson coming to center. Into Salming. With Vive, Salming going in, puts it up on the glass. Here comes Anderson. They move in quickly enough. Anderson again gets set. Back to the line. Salming, knocked down, rebound is good. Anderson got the rebound and put it up high after Salming made the shot on Beaupre and it fell in front.
Well, it's the guy we were talking about getting some production out of at the top of the show. And the Leafs with nothing. been going at all on their power play, finally let it click. And Johnny Anderson, in this case, is Johnny on the spot. As he dumps that rebound up over top of Beaupre, he made the save on Salming. And there you see it going up underneath the bar.
John Anderson the lead from Borja Salming and Gaston Gingras. Time 10:59.
There it is, 10:59. Power play goal by Anderson, his first, Salming and Gingras assisted.
Well, that brings him to life here in the gardens again, that Minnesota goal. Kind of quieted him down a little bit.
Jordy Douglas takes it to the left side with Bobby Smith at center ice now. Will he put on the right wing against Boudreau? Harris. And Boudreau starts out. Jimmy Corrin out playing on that left wing on that line now. His first turn. See how that leg is. There goes Corrin. Bumping with Smith again. He knocked him down. Jim Corrin playing up front. Benning and Shand are the two defensemen. There's Corrin. And he's hit by Smith at center ice. Corrin having difficulty skating. Call the play. Corrin and Smith have had it going all night, but Jim Corrin has not put in any ice time in the second period till now. Now Willie Putt comes over and has to chat to Corrin.
Well, he certainly takes advantage of the ice time he gets. Corrin is out there throwing his weight around. He helped give the Leafs some life. Clean check to Smith down in the corner. And he's up there right opposite Willie Plett. Left winger, right winger. They're certainly giving them all the opportunity in the world to have a go, aren't they?
They're jawing now. There's Plett.
Oh, boy.
He's a tough one.
Wayne Bonney's got a great job. He's right between them. He better get those guys back and maybe face off between Plett and Korn. Any way to keep them apart.
Plett. Tied up by Corrin, he shakes it loose, carries on. There's Bobby Smith getting in front. It was tipped by Douglas, but Palmatier blocked it. Now Boudreau is in roughing it up. Here comes Plett. And he ran into Harris on the boards. Again, a pileup of players. They're at close quarters down there to the right of Palmatier. We've got a Stanley Cup update for you now, and here's Dave Hodge.
A tie has been broken here. A tie now exists in Buffalo with Ryan Walter in the penalty box. John Van Boxmeer takes a shot from the point. If it hits anybody, it's a Montreal player because Van Boxmeer gets credit for the goal from Paul Sear and Mike Foligno. And Buffalo is tied with Montreal at a goal apiece.
So they're tied there, and here the Leafs have taken a one-goal lead, 2-1. Here's Giles, though. Paul McTeer clubbed that. Away from Douglas, he was in close. Shan played it in. There's Padovny trying to set it up to Preacher. Hurry out of Preacher to Padovny again, back to the net. Hartsburg had him covered. Now the North Stars starting out. Bobby Smith got away from Tyrion's check. Here's Smith, belted by Melrose. Smith got his stick up, so did Melrose. They collided. Getting rough again. Tyrion coming to center. To the far side, still has it. Perrion got away from Giles, and he went slamming into the boards. There's Podupny roughing it up. Preacher into the fray in there. Here comes Perrion again to Podupny. Podupny back to the goal. Trying to one-arm it out in front, getting some help from Preacher. Gingras going in. Perrion has it, the Leafs with the pressure on. But now Minnesota, four of them skate out across the line. They're four abreast going in. Hartsburg all the way with it, knocked down by Gingras. Puck is loose, back of the net. They still fight for Minnesota, up with it, Hartsburg. And it's knocked in behind the net. Eaves in front, they score! Bellows wrapped it home. With Eaves in front with him, but Bellows didn't need any help. And it's tied again at 2.
Well, you know, I thought the players, Bob, here thought the play was going to be called as that puck was in underneath Hartsburg. But he got up, came back, and made the big play to Brian Bellows right there. And he wasted no time. He buried it underneath Palmatier. And we're tied up again. Well, a quick wrist shot by Brian Bellows. He had 35 goals during the regular season, second only to Steve Larmer of Chicago, who led the league, or the rookie leagues, with 43 goals.
Bellows second of the series. Hartsburg and Payne assisting. 13:03 the time. Score tied at 2. 6:55 now left in the second period. Berlego with 5. And Anderson again for Toronto. Heaves up front with Payne and Bellows for Minnesota. Shan and Derlego, but Shan was in ahead of the play, offside. It was a tough time down here tonight. Wayne Bonney, one of the linesmen, fell to the ice. He's okay. To play. There's Derlego getting the draw. Bellows tied up by Anderson. Now Payne in behind Bellows with that pass. Here comes Eaves. Salming chasing Eaves. He's loose. Got a shot away. Payne went after it. Knocked down in front by Benning. Benning to the corner trying to clear it. Bellows going in. Now by a pass in behind Anderson. Poked at it. Chased after it, but Roberts is back first. Roberts looked hard. Bye-bye. Bye went after Payne and missed him. Now Salming coming back. Bellows upending.
There they go. Five and Payne are going to go, Bob. Of course, Payne has been guarding Five. This is the third game in a row now. McAdam has been on Freacher. Payne has been on Five, and finally, tempers get the best of them, and they'll both go to the box.
Live from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto, the Stanley Cup playoffs.
The first step to winning for Tracy Austin, Reggie Jackson, Earl Campbell, and Paolo Rossi is when they step into Pony from Collegiate Sports World. Pony shoes from Collegiate are tough enough to make it in any sport, cool enough to take the heat, and light enough to let your game take off and fly. Just ask Reggie.
Hi, this is Reggie Jackson. Now that you know how I feel about Pony shoes, how about stepping into a pair at Collegiate Sports?
Our Stanley Cup update game tonight is from Buffalo. The Canadians are there, and at the moment, they're tied at 1.
Well, Bob, here's how all that started out. Vive belting Gordy Roberts and then taking a run at Payne. And then as the play continued down the ice, Payne and Vive got at it. They're both in the penalty box a couple of minutes apiece. Will be four skaters aside.
Minnesota keeping it in on the draw. Cicerelli going after it. Cicerelli gets it back to the line. Maxwell gets set, doesn't shoot it. Big Billy Harrison carries on into the corner. Brock standing up in the slot area. Maxwell got in front. Oh. Great save by Mike Palmatier. Not Brock as he covered up. Now Martin is in with Harris. Can't play it over to him. Broughton turning around. He thought he had a goal. Broughton did. Now he loses it. But Roberts will bring it out with Cicerelli. Roberts across center coming in. Roberts waiting for help. Has to circle back to center with the North Stars making changes. Broughton again a shot. That missed the net. Cicerelli after Gingras. The latter clearing it. Up to Salming at center. Smith and Harris high sticking each other. Salming is in, taking a look at the far side, picked off, Creature let it go, and Beaupre stopped that. 50 seconds now left of the penalties. Payne and Vive. 2-2 tie, Bobby Smith is in. Shot stopped by Palmatier, who is knocked away by Shan. Smith against Melrose, with two players to the ice. Smith trying to hold it with a stick. Now it's grabbed. Onik Adam in front. Hartsburg is belted by Melrose. Bobby Smith around the net. It comes out to Creature. And Creature will bring it out. Creature to center. Smith going off. He's tired. He's been roughed up. Long shot stopped by Volpe. Creature again. Creature has done it again. How many times have we seen him make that same move this year? He does not stop, picked up the rebound, and scored.
Well, done it again is the word, Bob. He had nothing else to do. He just drove it at Beaupre. He left the rebound. Therrien got tied up with Kirk Giles. The puck laid right there, and Preacher went right for the front of the net and a loose puck and jammed it right underneath Beaupre. But the key word with Preacher is again, because he has done this all year long. And boy, has he played his heart out in this series in all these three games. Watch him after he goes in the corner. You see the puck laying there. Preacher heads straight for the front of the net. Bingo. It's in before the North Stars even can react. Leafs back in front.
3-2. That's Preacher's second of the series, unassisted at 15:46. The time. 3-2. Toronto with 4 minutes left in the period. Penalized players back. Paint going in. Right in. Whoa! Paul Maturin makes a great save, but they put it in the net.
It's in. Is it in?
I think the referee pointed to the face-off spot. Now we're going to wait. No, he pointed to the Minnesota player. It's a goal.
Paul Maturin made the original stop on Payne. And I believe it was the Leaf defenseman that piled in trying to back check. He couldn't hold up his momentum. And he piled into Palmateer and I believe knocked the puck into his own net. What an unfortunate break for the Leafs. Watch this one now. Who is it coming back? Salming. There's the save. It's Salming that falls over top. Watch this now. There it is. You can't miss it there. It is in the net. There's Payne all alone. Salming trying to get back. The big save by Palmateer. Here's Salming going up and over. And Benning also trying to get at it. He may have got a piece of it. Nevertheless, we're tied at 3.
16:08. Bellows and Roberts getting assists on the goal by Payne. Again, we have a Stanley Cup update. Here's Dave Hodge.
The Buffalo Sabres have gone in front of the Montreal Canadiens. They are trying to eliminate the Habs. And Lindy Ruff goes from the corner to the front of the net and with his backhand shot beats Rick Wamsley. That happened 65 seconds after Van Boxmeer tied the score. Buffalo 2 and Montreal 1 now.
So Buffalo on top again over there, but here it's tied at 3, just 22 seconds after Preacher had given the Leafs a 3-2 lead. Minnesota is back to tie it.
Well, we're going back and forth now, but the Leafs barely get that momentum going, and all of a sudden, bingo, that's a bad break for them, but boy, Palmateer made a great stop on Steve Payne. Let's have a look at it again here. Now watch the glove. He gets the trapper on it, and there comes Salming sliding, can't hold himself. Now, does Jim Benning touch it or not? We'll never know, really. It's underneath Palmateer, Salming, and Benning. There's Benning to your left. And nevertheless, it's in the net.
Well, we've seen this throughout this entire series. In Minnesota, the first two games, they changed hands. Yep. Leafs came back 4 times to tie. Ended up losing 5-4. They lost 5-4 in the second game. Had a lead at one point, a couple of points in that one. Minnesota came back. Tonight, same thing, Mickey.
The only two-goal lead we've had in the whole series is the Toronto in game two. They went up 2-0 right off the bat.
Here it's 3-3. With 3:30 left in the period. Now make that 3:26 as the Minnesota North Stars call for icing, so they'll bring it all the way back to the left of Beaupre.
Well, there's Mr. Harold Ballard's box, daughter Mary, and Mr. Munson Campbell in behind him. He is an ex-governor of the National Hockey League. Mr. Ballard been grabbing headlines all winter long, Bob, with his hockey team and his football team. Quite a character.
Quite proud of the Maple Leafs. Talked to him after that second game in Minnesota. Even though his team is down 2 games, he is still happy with the way the players have been performing.
Sure is.
He's delighted. Gonna hear from this team, he insists, very soon. Boudreau has it go through his skates. Bellows slapped it in. There's Bellows. He'll just tip it out. 3:15 to play in the period. Roberts is coming back. Score tied at 3. And Payne is away, coming in. Up over the line, Payne. Tried to drop it over on the other side. That hit Harris. All the tear into it. He got it high over the glass into the crowd. Called again. Boudreau with Harris and Martin for Toronto. Minnesota have made changes, so likely the Leafs will change also. Here comes Derlego with Vibe and Anderson. Broughton is on with Cicerelli and McCarthy.
Randy Velischek, number six for Minnesota, out there only his second or third shift of the night. The North Stars signed him very late in the season. I believe played the last two games. He had quite a career at Providence College, born in Montreal. They're looking for big things out of young Randy Velischek in the future.
Hartsburg, the other defenseman. Hartsburg from Stratford gets a shot away, and right away, Paul Battier, the swing at the Minnesota player who came in. That was Broughton. Paul Battier had made the save and had jumped on it.
Here is Randy Velischek. Something, isn't it, to come out of college hockey and right into the Stanley Cup playoffs? An awful lot of college players. The last count is 80-some college players in the National Hockey League.
Plus the high school sensation over in Buffalo, Phil Housley. That's something.
Sure is.
Score tied at three now, with 2:56 to play in this period. And from the draw, Salming back to the net. Broughton after him. Priest has it to Broughton. Salming pumped with it. Broughton still has his stick on it. Salming still after him. Broughton now has it again, overskated it. Fired by Gingras high, he flipped it.
Look out.
And look out is right.
Look out.
Pushing and shoving, Derlego and Priest.
Ronnie Priest. Something happened down in that pile up in front of the net. Priest turned and really tried to get after Derlego. Fortunately, the linesman right there. Well, we're setting up for a whale of a third period. Score tied. Leafs on the brink of elimination. Tempers flaring. And everybody's into it. Not just the tough guys. The resident tough guys like Plett and Korn, but boy, they're all throwing their weight around, Bob.
Jim Korn has a Charlie horse. He was on the ice for one shift in this period, playing up on the left wing to see how the sore muscle would respond. There he is, Jim Korn, on the leaf bench.
Little bench over in behind the regular leaf bench where Korn is sitting, not taking a regular shift. They get him back out of the way. The Leafs have seven defensemen dressed tonight with 19-year-old Gary Lehman in the lineup. Gingras coming back tonight. Lehman in the lineup. Reed Bailey went out. Had six for the first two games in Minnesota.
2:37 to play in the period. Score tied at three. Broughton, McCarthy to his left. Ferguson now, a runner Priest out on the right wing for Minnesota. Anderson has to come in. Derlego is out. Minnesota with the draw. Hartsburg the shot. In front. Broughton falls. Now it's cleared down the ice. No icing. It's been waved off. 2:25 to play. It is the second period, and McCarthy tipped it through the middle. Right to Shand of the Leafs. He got rid of it. Up to the Minnesota line, and here's Broughton again coming back in. Broughton, he didn't see that McCarthy was tied up by five. Couldn't move on the play. Hartsburg coming back. Goaltender, both plays stopping it for Hartsburg. The Leafs changing again. 2 minutes left in the period. McCarthy to center. North Stars on the move now. Ferguson on the right. Here's Ferguson and after it. Stopped by Podubny. Carry on watching him. And Podubny has it. Can't get loose though. Ferguson dropped it back. Next ball a shot. Tipped away by Paul Battier. And again, into the crowd. With 1:43 left of the period.
Volunteer down very early on that long shot from Neil Broughton. Gave him a lot of trouble. The Leafs doing a little bit of standing around in their own zone right now, and as a result, the North Stars are getting some scoring chances. Well, they've got to watch that Maxwell. He can really fire the puck. Already got himself a goal tonight. Got to stay out against him and cover him.
They've outshot the Leafs 33-23 up to this point. 1:43 left in the period. But the score is even. It's 3-all. Bobby Smith stopped. Maxwell's shot. Ripped it wide. Off the boards, McAdam took the shot, and Paul Battier grabbed that. Carrion got the only goal in the first period to give the Leafs the lead. A little pushing and shoving again. Maxwell tied it. Anderson gave the Leafs the lead again. Bellows tied it. Preacher put the Leafs out front. 3-2, and then Payne at 16:08 here on the second period from Bellows and Roberts. It's tied at three.
Well, this time it's Salming and Plett into it. Do they come together after Valmatier freezes the puck? And here comes Korn. Oh, boy.
Jimmy Korn off the bench. There he is.
How do you do? Hi, Willie. Hi, Jim. Well, let's do it again.
I just thought I'd come out for a ship, Willie, and see if the leg is okay.
Yeah, right.
Score tied at 3. Minute and a half left in the period.
Look at them. They're going at it right now.
Bobby Smith got the draw. Comes back to Roberts. A shot. All the tears saw it come through. Made the save. There's Korn. Here comes Plett. Plett running into Korn. They call it. Light bumping, little shoving, little pushing. Gloves still on.
I'll tell you what. They're both gone. You might have known this was going to happen. See you later, boys, says Andy Van Helleman. They're both going to grab a couple of minutes, and they'll go straight to the dressing room for an early rest. Jimmy Korn better go over there. He'll get an extra 2 minutes.
Plett has left. There he goes. Willie Plett and Jimmy Korn the other way.
Andy Van Helleman not fooling around at all with them. Got the trouble out of the way before it started. But they'll be back.
For Willie Plett, a 10-minute misconduct.
Oh.
Toronto penalty to number 20, Jim Korn, a 10-minute misconduct. Time 18:39.
Well, he took care of them a little more than we thought.
He won't be back for a while.
Andy said, my job toughen up out here, fellas. I'm going to give you guys a rest to make it a little easier.
18:39.
You know, that could really hurt, but Korn's not even playing much, Bob, but Plett on that power play for Minnesota is very effective. That could hurt the North Stars.
North Stars keeping it in. McAdam gets it in front. Good save by Paul Vatier. Bobby Smith left in front of the net. He's in there again, but Preacher gets a chance to clear it and does with a minute left in the period. Coming in with Podupny and Therrien. Therrien gets set. Dropped it there. And the North Stars pick it up quickly. 55 seconds left. Here's Bobby Smith. Preacher hit him. Sent him flying. Roberts coming out around Therrien. Roberts getting away. Therrien stole it. It goes right to the corner. 35 seconds left. What a move by Therrien, stealing it, going in. But now Bobby Smith the other way. Smith cutting in. Smith handling, turned it up. Smith back of the goal. There's going to be a penalty to the Leafs on that high stick against Bobby Smith, I believe. It hit him high, and the Leafs will get a penalty here with 24 seconds left in the period.
Much question at all about this call. It's going to be Benning who gets it. Three or four Leafs took a whack at Bobby Smith. Boy, that gets dangerous when sticks get up around the eyes and the head area. Take a look at this action. There's a slash by Benning right there, and there's a second one. It catches Bobby Smith up around the head. Boy, there's no need for that kind of stuff. And look at the work that Greg Therrien's doing. Back checking, stealing the puck from Gordy Roberts. And the two-on-one with Podupny used him as a decoy and ripped it high and wide of Beaupre. Boy, Bob, those sticks get up around the head area. They're dangerous. Fortunately for Smith, that time he had a helmet, I'm sure.
Well, now here, Mickey, with 24 seconds left in the period, a great opportunity for the Minnesota North Stars. Volvatier tried to shoot it on the glass, I'm sure, and get it down the ice, but it went over and into the crowd, so the faceoff will be back in the lead zone. 21 seconds left.
Already you see the difference now with the North Stars without Willie Plett. They've got a different line out in the power play.
Payne is on with Bellows and Broughton.
Usually it's McAdam, Smith, and Plett.
Maxwell and Hartsburg. The two Minnesota defensemen. It comes to Hartsburg. Hartsburg shot. That was right at Harris. It comes to center. Now Maxwell at his line. 12 seconds left in the period. Minnesota moving to center. Leafs break it up, shoot it in. Good penalty killing by Martin. 5 seconds left. Martin in to watch Payne. 3 seconds left in the period. And the horn goes to end the second period, and they have solved absolutely nothing or nearly nothing as the teams are in a deadlock. And the shots in the second period were, well, over a two-period total. It's Minnesota 36 and Toronto 23, Minnesota 27, Toronto 11 in that period. And so the score at the end of the second period, Minnesota 3 and Toronto 3.
shining bright. This is the light. Hey, what a day.
Hey, what a day.
Riding the breeze, taking it easy.
With the works, introducing the special Street Smart Capri. For $500 less, you get everything on it. Sport performance seats, leather-wrapped wheel, tinted glass, two-tone paint, and stripes.
Plus a great flip-up roof.
The Street Smart Capri, priced $500 less.
How street it is.
Capri.
I'll have one.
The special Capri at your Mercury dealers. At this price, hurry. They're going fast.
Over the years, your changing fuel needs have caused changes in us.
Morning, Joe. Time for gasoline.
In 1939, Esso introduced their new premium.
Esso Extra, please.
With the post-war car boom, the need for gasoline grew. Then came lower-cost self-serve.
Fill her up.
Yes, sir.
Unleaded gasoline.
Premium unleaded, please.
Diesel. And down the road, propane and future fuels. Anticipating your needs makes us better.
You make us better, you do.
If we took a long-lasting Duracell battery, shaped it like this, added a high-impact handle, a flashing safety light, and a swivel head with a beam visible up to half a mile, and called it a Durabeam, what would you say?
It's gotta last.
Right, and it'll shine bright even after 2 years in storage. Durabeam, in a full range of sizes. Durabeam, powered by Duracell, to last.
CBC News with Peter Mansbridge.
Among tonight's top news stories, the space shuttle Challenger is back on Earth. It landed in California this afternoon after 5 days in space. The shuttle performed perfectly in its five-day mission. The flight included the first U.S. spacewalk in almost a decade. In Louisiana, people living near the Pearl River are bracing for more floods. The river is rising to record levels. In other parts of the state, though, the waters are beginning to recede. There's more news in the case of three trust companies seized by the Ontario government. Bill Player, the man who arranged the sale of thousands of apartments on behalf of the trust companies, says he will sue the Ontario government for $1.2 billion. We'll have more on these and other stories later tonight on The National. Now, back to Hockey Night in Canada.
Three times in this game, the Maple Leafs have had one-goal leads, and three times the North Stars have come back to tie the score, which explains the score that you see on your screen. In the second period, Maxwell tied it for Minnesota, then Anderson put the Leafs in front. Bellows tied it for Minnesota, Preacher restored the Leafs' one-goal lead, and then Steve Payne tied it for the third time with his 30th career playoff goal, although this one he did not actually put into the net himself. The North Stars have been credited with 27 shots on goal in that second period alone, to which one might say unbelievable. And that's a word that's heard a lot when watching hockey. And if it's unbelievable, maybe it's magic.
Thank you.
Howie Meeker is known for his ability to explain everything but magic in a hockey game, and he'll do that when he opens his NHL playbook as we return with the Stanley Cup playoffs in just a moment.
They come from near and far with names like Bill and Frank and Joanne, but they all share the same initials, GE. And with those initials comes a special feeling of pride, the pride of bringing good things to life.
Trust Seiko for advanced dual display technology even 300 feet beneath the sea. Trust Seiko for watches that display any of six timekeeping functions with a turn of the bezel. For alarm chronographs that even measure your pulse rate. Seiko watches and clocks, the most advanced performers in timekeeping. No wonder people trust Seiko more than any other watch.
From years of clinical research comes new Colgate with mineral-building fluorides, providing significantly more cavity protection than ever before. Here's why. Teeth contain minerals. This is a magnified picture of a healthy tooth. Cavities start when teeth lose minerals. Colgate's mineral-building fluorides help replace lost minerals, so cavities can't start. Colgate toothpaste is recognized by the Canadian Dental Association. Today's Colgate, significantly more cavity protection.
Each team has a power play goal in tonight's game, but each team has missed on three other power play opportunities. The subject of Howie Meeker's NHL playbook tonight, penalty killing.
It's time for NHL playbook. Let's turn to penalty killing using the box.
Trust Seiko for advanced dual display technology even 300 feet beneath the sea. Trust Seiko for watches that display any of six timekeeping functions with a turn of the bezel. For alarm chronographs that even measure your pulse rate. Seiko watches and clocks, the most advanced performers in timekeeping. No wonder people trust Seiko more than any other watch.
From years of clinical research comes new Colgate with mineral-building fluorides, providing significantly more cavity protection than ever before. Here's why. Teeth contain minerals. This is a magnified picture of a healthy tooth. Cavities start when teeth lose minerals. Colgate's mineral-building fluorides help replace lost minerals, so cavities can't start. Colgate toothpaste is recognized by the Canadian Dental Association. Today's Colgate, significantly more cavity protection.
Each team has a power play goal in tonight's game, but each team has missed on three other power play opportunities. The subject of Howie Meeker's NHL playbook tonight, penalty killing.
It's time for NHL playbook. Let's turn to penalty killing using the box. With the box so tight, there's only one place for the puck to go, and that's out to the point. Watch in front of the net. Goalkeeper can see the puck, easily makes a save. The box again is formed tight, the puck goes to the point, and look at the defenseman clean house, so the goalie makes an easy save. Puck is retrieved by the Canucks. They set up again, and they try to sneak someone into the slot. But here, just take a look. The box is tight. It's overloaded on one side. There's only one possible place the puck can go. It's out to the point. No one in front, and the goalkeeper makes an easy save. That's the way to kill a penalty. The Edmonton Oilers in trouble. They're a man short. Look at that tight box situation they're in. The only place the puck can go to is out to the point. A deflection into the corner. Now watch them change situations. The other side of the ice. They still get back into that short, tight box situation so that puck cannot go through the middle or get a clean shot on the net. There's the box. Now watch what's going to happen here. A desperation shot. No chance of it going in. And Mr. 99, Mr. Gretzky, is killing a penalty. Watch this. It is just super. Only a Wayne Gretzky could get away with taking the puck back into his own end. And hey, folks, I want to see that again. If you've got a Wayne Gretzky on your team killing penalties, just get him the puck and he'll do the rest. Folks, that's penalty killing at its very best.
In Buffalo, the Sabres continue to lead Montreal 2-1, but Buffalo is killing a penalty, trying to hold that one-goal lead, and when we return, we'll go to the auditorium live in the third period. Hockey Night in Canada continues in just a moment.
You should get your next tune-up at Canadian Tire.
You know, a tune-up is only as good as the guy who does it. Sure, equipment, even computers are important, but you want a guy who knows what he's doing. A certified mechanic who'll tend to all those little details. You want a guy who's proud of what he's doing, so he'll make sure the job's done right. You know, I'm a guy like that. Hey! Oh, and so are all these other guys.
There's a lot more to Canadian Tire than tires.
The company that has sparked more engines than any other company in the world now introduces Guaranteed Performance. If you don't agree that fresh Champion spark plugs make your car run better, return the plugs to Champion within 60 days, and we'll give you your money back. So no matter what kind of car you drive, get Guaranteed Performance from Champion, because nothing sparks like a champion. Guaranteed.
Lynx efficiency and performance take on new meaning in the front-wheel drive Lynx RS. With a 1.6-liter high-output engine, 5-speed transmission, and TR suspension standard, the Lynx RS is the hottest Lynx on wheels. The Lynx family, from its new Fuel Saver model through to its 3- and 5-door hatchbacks and wagons, performs beautifully. Mercury Lynx, out of the ordinary, but not out of range.
Third down to 10. Who's gonna win? Hey, what a game. Feeling so proud, laughing out loud. Hey, what a great day.
Break away.
With a taste that's clean and clear. Molson Canadian, the great Canadian.
The father of conservation, the man from Kingsville, Ontario, who created the world's first bird sanctuary, Wild Goose Jack, Sunday.
Well, that Buffalo penalty is just about over as we check the Memorial Auditorium. Gilbert Perreault standing up in the penalty box, and as we send you to Buffalo, he's probably out by now.
Takes a look, lays it over on the other side, and that was a red-shirted Canadian who was there, shot. Buffalo in front, 2-1. And it is the third period with 13 minutes and 15 seconds remaining. Now behind the net, up on the boards. Here's Knott first winding up for the shot. Oh!
The viewers who have been watching the Maple Leafs and the Minnesota North Stars have joined us here in Buffalo. 12:56 left in regulation time. The Buffalo Sabres lead the Canadiens 2-1. And Robert Sauvé, who blanked the Canadiens twice in Montreal but didn't have all that much work, especially in the second game, has been magnificent here in game three in Buffalo. There's a perfect example right there with the save, the drive fired his way by Rick Natras. So the Canadians are facing elimination here in the third period. They are down by one, but they've had a good part of the territorial play. Sauvé has been brilliant.
So the Canadians again with everybody out. 12 minutes and 56 seconds remaining in regulation time, and the Sabres get the draw. They've been executing that particular facet of the game brilliantly in this series, getting faceoffs in their own zone. The players struggle on the boards. Now here's Acton cutting out the board, cutting in front, blocked by Sauvé. And again, Sauvé with a scrappy piece of goaltending.
It actually hit him in the mask. He's standing up there challenging them, daring them to score.
Now it's back into the center ice area. Acton went in there, but he failed to take the puck with him. McKechnie is coming back in over the line with Sear. Here goes to the right wing boards, doesn't follow in. It is Green working it out for the Canadians. Acton was upended. Now out over the line comes Playfair. He shot it down in over the line.
We'll keep you posted on the third period of that Montreal-Buffalo game. Right now the difference, a goal by Buffalo's number 22, Lindy Ruff. And speaking of number 22, Rick Vive is still scoreless in this series, and you wonder how much longer the Leafs can last if their captain remains off the score sheet. He will try to do something about that as the Leafs try to go in front for the fourth time. As we get set to start the third period of play, here's Bob and Mickey.
Thank you, Dave. Tyrion gave the Leafs a 1-0 lead in the first period, and then in the second, you see it there, Maxwell tied it. Anderson, the Leafs lead again. Bellows tied it. Freecher, the Leafs lead again. And then Payne from Bellows and Roberts at 16:08. And look at the shots. Minnesota outshooting Toronto 27-11 in that second period. Two period total, 36-23. If there is another game of this series, it'll be tomorrow night here at Maple Leaf Gardens, 7 o'clock Eastern time, the start. Dave, Mickey, and I will be here again if there is a fourth game. And Mike Nicolak hopes, of course, there will be. He insists there will be. He was saying this morning he is so very, very proud of his hockey players. So many injuries, so many regulars out. The fill-ins have been superb. And the rest of the team picked up the slack. They lost two games in Minnesota, two heartbreakers, especially game two. Both games 5-4 the score. The second one, as you know, in overtime. Bobby Smith, the hero in both games. Bobby Smith has been slowed down a bit tonight. He came in for some heavy hitting in the first and second period. There he is with the puck. Bobby Smith moving in, gets in close to Maxwell. Shooting, stopped by Palmatier. Rebound, scramble for it. Smith couldn't get it by Borja Salming. The Minnesota North Stars pressure on again. They bring it right to the Leafs here, beginning of the third period. Bellows waits for the pass. He won't get it. It'll go to Maxwell. There he is. He slides it back to Smith. Smith dragging it a bit. Hartsburg passes off to Bellows. Maxwell again to Smith again. Shot stopped. Shot again by Smith. Up high, over the net. Great pressure by Minnesota. Another shot on the tier. Has been overworked in this hockey game again. Nothing new to Paul Mateer, and he's been hot. We have now a Stanley Cup update for you from Buffalo. Let's check in with Dave.
Just after we left the action at the Memorial Auditorium in Buffalo, the Canadians tied the score. A familiar combination. Steve Schutt and Guy Lafleur. Schutt doesn't have the puck yet, obviously, but Lafleur does. Schutt gets up, takes a pass, and lofts a backhander that beats Bob Sauvé. Montreal's second goal of the series, second goal of the game. It is tied in the third period at Buffalo.
So the Canadians
Canadians, Mickey, are staying in it.
They're tied now at two, and what a finish they've got over there in Buffalo tonight. On the power play for Minnesota now, 29 seconds left in the Benning penalty.
Well, don't forget the ending of the season, Bob. Canadians were beaten by Buffalo at the Forum. They went right back into Buffalo on a Sunday night and beat the Sabres 7-4, so they can do it in the Buffalo Auditorium.
Now the Leafs trying to clear it. They will. Gavin and Therrien coming in. Gavin to Therrien. He nearly tipped it up the netminder, Don Beaupre. 18 seconds left in the Leafs penalty. Look at the work of Gavin killing this penalty. Bumping in there. Leafs break it up again. Minnesota starting back. Maxwell playing it in. That's McCarthy's shot. Up over Paul Letier's head. He just got out of the way of it. I don't know, but it might have. I think the wind scared him. Just ducked in time.
It's a good enough example for any goaltender to not be going down, as Paul Letier likes to do. That one just whistled by his ear. McCarthy really let it fly. It went directly off the glass into the stands. Watch Paul Letier's reaction here. A high shot. Holy mackerel. What am I doing here? Puck flying over 100 miles an hour in a shot like that.
In the penalty, just 2 seconds now. Benning is ready to come back on. So the Leafs have killed this penalty. Now Benning is on the ice. Maxwell shooting it in for Minnesota. They've been all over the Leafs on this power play. They still have a chance in there up to now. Terlego and Vibe coming in. That's Terlego, and he is stopped cold by Maxwell. North Stars bring it out. Maxwell, the defenseman, ahead to Ferguson. Melrose broke it up. Reese was bumped. He couldn't carry in. The Leafs bunching together, but now Anderson got the pass on his skate. Couldn't hold it. It was a hard pass right into his skates. Melrose shot. Just missed the far post. Dribbled by Beaupre and nearly went in. That's the way it has been for the Maple Leafs in this series. Close calls. Goal posts, and that one just dribbled by the far post. It's tied at three. They've played 2.5 minutes of the third period as Cicerelli comes in with Broughton and McCarthy. Therrien's line is on. Anderson trying to get off. Creature is on the right wing. Now Anderson starts to go to the bench. Still on there. Now he's off. Minnesota back. Long pass, Cicerelli. Coming in, Broughton. Cicerelli with the puck to Broughton. Slapped away by Salming. At the line, it's kept in. Salming knocked it down. Comes out. That pass too far for Podubny. Creature flipped into center. Therrien. Can't go by McCarthy. Salming finds it. 3.5 gone in the period. 3-3 tie. Benning shot kicked out by Beaupre. Back there is Veleshek. Intercepts in front of the net. Podubny didn't see it. Three Stars come to center ice on the Leafs. Bobby Smith, Ferguson is shot wide. Melrose played it ahead. Great action now. They're going both ways. Therrien and Podubny off the board. Podubny centered it. Smith is back for Minnesota. Melrose will keep it in. But Smith has it again. Melrose again. Shot in front, tip near the net. Beaupre, no problem. 4 minutes gone in the third period. The score tied at three. Leafs trying to fight back in this series. Minnesota can wind it up tonight with a win. Bobby Smith in on Shan. They push at each other, hold it on the boards. They get a whistle. Face off in the Leafs zone from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. This is Stanley Cup 83 on CBC.
Hold it. You ain't going home just yet.
I got me a big muffler problem here, boy, and you Top Guns are gonna fix it.
Ah, yes. Very fast. Very professional. Now, what's in this for me? What's this?
Midas muffler guarantee, Sheriff.
Ah, that's real cute, boy.
No, sir. Just real good.
It's tied here in Toronto at three, and Buffalo are up. Date game tonight. match tied there at 2-2. Winding down toward overtime. The Canadians trying to hang on as the Buffalo Sabres threaten to wind up that series quickly. Boudreau on again. Number 12. Harris and Martin on the wings. That's Harris. Steve Payne with Bellows and Eaves for Minnesota. As the Leafs come out, Harris to center. Harris has some room over there now. Going in. Harris upended. Leafs nearly get a break. That was Harris back on his feet. Nearly picked it up. Now the Minnesota North Stars offside. That's Payne getting the pass over the two lines.
The folks here hollering for a penalty as Billy Harris was dragged down on the far side. He made a couple of good moves and almost ended up getting that puck back as a gift. Gordy Roberts right here. Well, he just put the elbow on him. Billy really fell down. It was off stride. But an errant pass by the North Stars almost ended up on Harris' stick back in front of the net. What a goal this guy, that Gordy Roberts scored the other night in Minnesota. End-to-end rush. Beautiful.
We're tied at 3. Third period. Game 3. As Harris goes in with Boudreau and Martin. They don't hang on to it very long. Minnesota tearing it. That's Ferguson. Lost it against Boudreau, who stayed with him. Now Boudreau again, tapped it to center. Melrose knocked him down, though. Giles was belted by Shan. Play called. Boy, it gets hot down there every now and then. Tonight's Stanley Cup playoff game is coming to you from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto.
Here's one they don't need us for.
Who doesn't need us?
Polaroid. Their new sun camera is $30 less than last year, and you still get a piece of the sun and a light mixer.
Can you still turn bad light into good pictures?
Yep. It's designed for 10 great shots out of 10. Use a 600-speed film.
Swell. For $30 less?
Yep, it'll sell itself.
But somebody has to tell the people about it.
But not both of us.
So that means...
Goodbye.
Bob, you talk about tempers flaring. There's why they started to flare there. Shan stood up Kurt Giles at the Leaf blue line. Al McAdam came in very quickly, but nothing developed. And we're set to go.
Eaves at center with Bellows and Payne on the wings. Anderson, 5, Derlego for Toronto. Bellows coming in, always dangerous. Missed the far post by a foot. Back of the net, Benning from the corner. Benning takes a look ahead. Can't get it up to Anderson, who's bumped. Anderson got it out to the line. Now Anderson to center with Derlego and Vibe catching up. Anderson going in, fanned on the pass. Lost the puck. Back for Bellows. Eames from a high shot. Bounced off the glass. Right down in front, and Anderson is back. Sweeping away is Anderson. Has some speed up now. Anderson going in. With the pass, back. Upended penalty coming up. Against the Minnesota North Stars. This is Hockey Night in Canada from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto.
Hi, Nick. Say, that's a fair amount of money.
Mm-hmm. Just a couple of months' pay. See you tonight, Trish.
Where are you going? What's he doing with that money? Oh, no.
Don't be mad, Trish. I blew a couple of months' pay. But I think you're worth it.
Oh, Nick.
Well, a great chance here for the Leafs as Anderson puts a move on Kurt Giles. And he almost got around him that time, but the knee went out. Down went Anderson, and up come the Leafs on the power play.
Horn and Plett have a little more than 8 minutes remaining in their misconduct penalties. Ingraz on the ice again. He has been used sparingly. Passes in. Terry on center. Creature. He got it lit up. Score! I tell you, McGee, I don't know if you can say too much about Miroslav Creature in this series, but he is one cool customer.
Well, I don't think he's going to get the goal, Bob. I think it deflected off of Walter Podubny's stick in front of Beaupre. He tucked it underneath his pads. between the legs, but Preacher made the move as the puck came loose. Therrien, as you see here, really started it out. Gave it to Preacher. Now watch him. There's the little pass to Podubny, and there it is. Beaupre almost got it. It caught his goal stick in his blocker hand, but trickled underneath him. And a big goal for the Leafs just 10 seconds after that penalty.
5:51 the time. 4-3, Toronto in the lead. But what work by Preacher setting that up. Therrien also gets an assist on the goal. So the Leafs in front again by a goal. Bobby Smith now. Shot stopped by Paul Mathieu. Crowd coming to life again. Lehman, number 16, on the ice again for Toronto. There he is in the corner. Therrien couldn't get it out. High shot by Smith as he was falling. He can shoot him from all angles.
Lost his mask. Fortunately, the Leafs iced the puck. Bobby Smith got a super shot away. He was being tied up. He was on his knees, and he still almost tucked it in the top corner. As Palmatier jumped after it, the mask came loose.
The Leaf bench, Mickey, over there, really going. As they crowd Podubny and Preacher, they come
off. They're excited. Well, here's that action again on the power play. Therrien again starts it out to Preacher and over to Podubny. He just gets the stick on it. Look at that. Right underneath the legs of Donnie Beaupre. No chance on the play for Beaupre. And the crowd here again with a chance. 41-27 shots on goal, favor of Minnesota.
13:28 left of the third period. In our update game, it's getting late over in Buffalo. It's tied at 2, Canadians in Buffalo. We'll keep you posted on action there. Here, the Leafs have taken the lead again. The fans behind them now with a chant, go Leafs, go. You can hear them. Center ice. Giles shoots it in. These two teams are putting on a whale of a series here in Stanley Cup 83. Two games of Minnesota, humdingers, both ending in 5-4 scores. For Minnesota, the second one in overtime, and now Giles coming in. Giles gets set. Low shot, not too much on it. Shan was all over him. Hartsburg, hit the skate of Giles. It goes to Paul Mathieu, out to Martin. Martin missed it. Martin is on there now with Boudreau and Rick Fine. Boudreau going off, so does Martin. Five couldn't stop Hartsburg. Hartsburg cutting for the net. Dangerous rush. Only shot through the crease. Five coming out to center with Derlego and Anderson. Five going in. To Derlego right in on goal. Can't get a shot away. He couldn't get the shot away, and Five set him up beautifully. Solving now. Ball to the ice. Two players. Go flying. Five is down. Against the Minnesota North Stars. With a score, Toronto 4, Minnesota 3. This is Stanley Cup 83.
When you buy something from Canadian Tire, it's not the end of our relationship, it's the beginning. Because we know there's more to a good value than just a good price. So we stand behind our products to make sure they do what they're supposed to for as long as they're supposed to. At Canadian Tire, we'll be there when you need us.
Night.
Another reason why there's a lot more to Canadian Tire than tires.
Got to get that score right. There's the scuffle inside the Minnesota line. 4-3 Toronto. And there's the penalty.
Well, Bratton hauled down Ricky Vive. The crowd was hauling for a penalty just before that on Salming as he was dumped. But nevertheless, the Leafs took 10 seconds, the last power play, to go ahead. Let's see what they can do here.
Bratton, the call for interference. 7:44 the time. Great opportunity now, Mick, for the Leafs to get a little breathing room. If you can call two goals in this series, breathing room.
Well, you know the North Stars aren't going to quit. They're a heck of a hockey club.
Five to Anderson in the corner. Five gets it back, but there's Eves, a great penalty killer. Eves coming out. Eves to center with McAdam. Oh, and it was tipped up the line, and Eves in behind everybody. Anderson turning again. There he goes, up over the line, trying to go in, spun around, out of the net is Beaupre. Shingrock keeping it in. played it ahead. Gingra wakes up the line. Anderson tried to boot it back to him. There's Gingra with the puck, fired it into by, but went by him. And they call it as Beaupre hangs onto it. Another Stanley Cup update with Dave Hodge.
Just over 4 minutes to play in Buffalo. This shot stopped by Rick Wamsley. This shot stopped by Rick Wamsley. And here's a rebound. Tony McKegney has scored to put the Sabres in front. 3-2. Late in the game.
Thank you, David. So it's nervous time again for the Montreal Canadiens with the Buffalo Sabres leading by a goal, and that is very late. And that game over there will keep you posted. Dave is watching the monitor, which has the Buffalo-Montreal game on it. We'll have the highlights for you. Here, Mickey, it's getting down to the bitter end, too, with the Leafs leading by one goal and 11:40 left in this one.
Well, Vive having a talk with Andy Van Helleman right now. He went into Beaupre. They had a little scuffle as play was called. But no damage is done, and we're ready to go again.
Leafs get the draw. They keep it in. Salming with a minute 20 left in the penalty to Bratton. Hadubny to the side. Therrien around the net. Therrien looking back. Gingra pointing up. Rebound is there. Hadubny has it. Gingra might get another shot. Goes to the corner. Goes to Hadubny. There's Gingra. Gingra to Hadubny. They move it around. Trying to spring somebody loose. Hadubny. Good save by Beaupre. Move quickly. Salming keeping it in. Back of the net, Creature. Creature went after it. He has it. Three Leafs behind the net. Creature turning around. Great puck control by Creature to Hadubny. In front it comes. Now Gingra turns. Gingra to Salming. The shot deflected into the crowd by Therrien. 34 seconds left on the penalty. 4-3 is the score. Toronto and now Plett and Korn will return to the ice.
Well, the Leafs have some great pressure on, but not able to get it behind Beaupre. And here's our second final of the night. The Nordiques gave off elimination. Randy Bowler, Dale Hunter, a shorthanded goal in that game, beat the Bruins 2-1. Ricky Middleton scoring for Boston.
So nothing is over yet. And the Leafs staving off elimination here with 10:50 left. They're leading by a goal. They're still on the power play. 33 seconds left. Gingra coming in with Derlego. He gets in front. Derlego falls. Rebound is there. Anderson again. Salming to Anderson. Anderson to Gingra. Knocked away. A hard shot. It slides back. That's a glove pass. It's called. The referee on the play calls it. It'll come outside the line for the faceoff, but what a shot. Gingra walked into it, and Beaupre blocked it.
Boy, Andy Van Helleman right on the spot to make this call. There's a big save by Don Beaupre. Five unable. Boy, is he frustrated. Can't pick up that rebound. And John Anderson with a little tap of the glove on the puck trying to get it back to Salming. An alert Andy Van Helleman makes the call, therefore the faceoff outside the Minnesota blue line with only 11 seconds left in Neil Broughton's penalty.
Derlego with five, and Anderson, Benning, and Salming. Toronto 4, Minnesota 3, Benning to Salming. Shooting it in. That will do it on the penalty. Broughton is standing up, ready to come back on. Derlego and Anderson are in there. Anderson couldn't knock it down. Broughton into the play again. The penalty is over, and Maxwell for Minnesota. Now then, the Stars will try to do something about that one-goal lead the Maple Leafs have at the moment. Derlego. Bellows is up front with Bobby Smith. And here's a break for Derlego. Look out! Just missed that far post. He was hauled down, but got a weak shot away and just missed the post. Bobby Smith on the move. Bellows has it. Couldn't make a play. Derlego fired it off the boards down the ice. That might be icing. Just misses the goal crease. So, as Giles touches it, icing is called. Hockey Night in Canada will continue in a moment.
With the quality upgrading system, I feel we get the job done 100%.
job one quality. At Ford of Canada, it's a team effort right down the line.
This is teamwork at its best. And I'll put the quality of this product up against all the other competition.
Quality job one.
Better and better. See what we've done at Ford. Quality is job one.
Billy D getting another opportunity. Bobby almost, as he was going down, got that one up in the top corner. Well, Bill's had a lot of opportunities these three games, hasn't he?
Right from the opening whistle in the first game, he's been blistering shots at the net and just missing. Got one. Jam. Cleared it out. 9:30 left in the third period. Toronto 4, Minnesota 3. Here's Boudreaux. Coming in with Martin and Harris. Bad pass, but Harris is on it. He scores! Boudreaux might get that goal. A weird, weird goal for the Maple Leafs. But to be fair to them, they've had their share of weird goals against them in this series.
I have a feeling this puck touched Bruce Boudreaux. He started the play out, made a bad pass to Harris, but watch what Billy Harris does. Nothing else to do, he throws it at the net. It hits Bruce Boudreaux in the skate and went right between the pads of Donnie Beaupre. That's two goals in a row that have been deflected right at the last minute. A very unfortunate break for the North Stars.
But assist number
a big
15
break for the
Bill
Leafs.
Harris.
5-3.
Time 10:42. Bruce Boudreaux from Bill Harris. Time 10:42.
Boudreaux from Harris at 10:42. Icing called against Minnesota on that play. They'll bring it all the way back, and the Leafs have come up now to a two-goal lead, 5-3.
Well, that's only the second time in the series, and look at this score in Winnipeg. They're leading the high-flying Edmonton Oilers. They're playing Howerchuk for Winnipeg and Paul Coffey for the Oilers. And Chicago still leading on goals by Wilson and Savard at St. Louis tonight. Trying to take a 2-1 lead in the series. The Rangers trying to sweep Philadelphia. At Madison Square Garden, McClanahan, Gressner, and Beck. And Clark for the Flyers. Well, let's see if we can see this little deflection, Bob, and a high angle shot here. Boudreaux going for the net. Harris just dumps it at the net. Look at this. Skater stick. Nevertheless, it's in the net, and a happy Bruce Boudreaux and a happy Maple Leaf Garden for the two-goal lead for the Leafs.
And only 9 minutes to play in the period, but the two-on-one with Broughton going in. And he rattled one high. McCarthy was on his left. The Leafs get a two. Van Vliet. Down the ice to go, Anderson shoots. That went off Beaupre. Gerligo went sliding by the netminder then. He was catching up on the play. Young Gary Lehman seeing spot duty on the defense for the Maple Leafs. In from the Regina Pats, the junior team. Broughton going in now, hauled down. And there will be a penalty on that play. Okay, we have this Stanley Cup update for you. Let's go to Buffalo. Okay, and back here in Toronto. Salming is in the penalty box. A minute 34 left in his penalty. Minnesota with great pressure on the Maple Leafs, who are leading 5-3. Willie Platin on the boards, getting into the thick of things again for Minnesota. Along with Steve Payne, Shand and Therrien with Melrose of the Maple Leafs. Minute 29 left in Salming's penalty. The Maple Leafs on the Boudreaux goal here in the third period have opened up a 2-goal lead on Minnesota, and they're fighting to stay alive in this series, in which Minnesota leads by virtue of their two victories at home, 5-4 both times.
Well, Bob, if there is a fourth game, right now it looks like there is. Tomorrow night, 7 o'clock Eastern time, we'll have Bobby Orr and the Hockey Legends with part two of Gordie Howe. Looking forward to that. And there's a lot of people here in Toronto are looking forward to game four. They're hoping.
Bobby Smith with a draw. Tipped ahead by Bratton. Chan with a chance to clear. He's stopped back there by Payne. He set it up for Plett. He's bumped by Therrien. Bratton now from the line. A screenshot. Rebound to Smith. He jammed at it a second time. And Paul Bettier grabs it. And right away, Melrose is there to protect the little goaltender. Salming has a minute and 12 seconds left on his penalty. Maple Leafs hang on to that 2-goal lead. Therrien goes off and he gets a big hand.
Well, he should too. He's done a great job here tonight. What a great penalty killer he is. Greg Therrien for the Leafs, three shorthanded goals this season, as did Ricky Vive and Jim Korn. Minnesota has given up 20 shorthanded goals against their power play, highest in the National Hockey League this year.
Here's the score with the shots at this point reading Minnesota 44 and Toronto 32. But the Leafs have that 2-goal lead, 5-3, 7:44 remaining.
A lot of shots in all these games, Bob, in this series.
McCarthy, Bellows, Cicerelli for Minnesota. They get the draw. Maxwell is at the line and gets it. To Bellows, turning in the slot. Hartsburg, rebound! Bellows nearly had one, but Paul Bettier made the save. Harris brings it in. With Martin now! His shot hit a leg. Maxwell blocked it. 50 seconds left in the Salming penalty. The lead's changing quickly. Coming back, Minnesota on the power play. Maxwell bumped up the line. It's kicked out by Gavin, actually, that time. Minnesota, Bellows in again. Bellows, dangerous right winger for Minnesota. And the youngster played it in around the net, but now Gavin fired it off the boards, down the ice. 24 seconds. And Salming will be back on. Toronto lead by two. Hartsburg upended. Melrose and Vive. Chance for Gavin. Got a pass on the skate. Vive open on the wing. The shot stopped by Beaupre. 5 seconds left in the Salming penalty. Minnesota's power play coming in again. Giles right in and stopped by Paul Bettier. And Salming is back on, and the crowd here at the Gardens are loving it. Now they're getting up.
Well, there's that final, Bob, out of Buffalo. Montreal is gone for the third year in a row. Boy, oh boy. Hard to believe, but the Sabres and Scotty Bowman will get a rest as the crowd here gives a standing ovation to the Maple Leafs. And there's a look at the congratulations being handed out in Buffalo. 4-2, the Sabres have won it in three straight games.
There's Bob Berry behind Wamsley, the Canadian coach, and you know how he feels tonight. His team going into the series better than an even shot of defeating Buffalo, but losing the first two without getting a goal.
I know it's so good for Buffalo in that case. They get a chance to rest now and wait for other series and other teams to meet them.
The Leafs here leading 5-3. 6:20 remaining in the third period. Giles for Minnesota having difficulty against Anderson. Giles, though, shakes it off. Comes in. Smith bad on the shot. Plett back to the net. Willie Plett to Smith. Around the net he goes. Centered it. Nobody there. And it'll go back. Salming broke his stick, goes to the bench for a new one. Here's Anderson, he might pick it up. And he brings it outside the line with Derlego and Vive in front of the net. Now Minnesota regrouping, Benning covering up of the line. The lead's just checking very closely now. They're leading by two. Wholesale changes. McCarthy in. Hit shot deflected away. Creature tying up his man. Hartsburg at center. Podubny, Krejci, Therrien again. Look at this. Krejci going in with Podubny. feature. And again, he went this side.
Oh, he got
took a Beaupre and could not get the puck in. And I think there's a penalty coming
cut.
Up.
Boy.
But, you know, the other night in the second game, Mickey, in Minnesota, Preacher got that break and went in on Beaupre, made that move, same as he did right there, and hit the side of the net. Live from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto, the Stanley Cup playoffs.
You wanted defense, great engine defense. So we made our motor oil better. FZO Uniflow, our best. Against heat, against corrosion, against engine wear. You wanted better defense, so we made a better motor oil. SO Uniflow.
You make us better, you do. SO.
42.
Well, you can tell by the roar of the crowd here at the Gardens. A 5-minute major to Craig Hartsberg of the North Stars for high sticking as he clipped Miroslav Krejčí on a 2-on the goaltender breakaway from center ice. And Krejčí kept it himself. Let's see, he steals it right there from Hartsberg. And look at that vicious swipe he took. That's where he got cut right there on the right ear. He missed the breakaway. What a vicious swing by Craig Hartsberg. What's this again?
Mickey, watch him get up and get back into it from his knees. Look at
he
that.
He got KO'd by the stick. He is cut. Therefore, the 5-minute major for Hartsberg. And boys, you got to keep those sticks down. That is not needed.
He went to his knees, Preacher did, as you saw, with that high stick over the eye, got back up and struggled toward the net. And now, Mickey, with 5:10 left in the third period, the Leafs have a power play that has another 4:45 left on it. So it looks pretty good for the Maple Leafs at this point to extend the series. But you never know what can happen. This Minnesota team, as you said earlier, will not quit. These two teams have put on a great show in this series. Here's Chérion, got away from that check. Then he was hit by a second man, Bellows. There's Lehman, Gary Lehman, 16. Pretty cool playing his first game in a Stanley Cup series. Third period, on the power play, 3:55. Derlego broke it up. Coming in with five. Back to the line, Gingras stepping in. Fires it, and the shot deflected wide of the net. Grabbed by Benning and Maxwell, and the play is called. Toronto 5, and Minnesota 3. They have now 3:57 remaining in the third period. And a face-off in the Minnesota zone. We now welcome you, viewers, who have been watching the Buffalo Sabres eliminate the Montreal Canadiens in three straight games in that series. This is Bob Cole with Mickey Redmond in the gondola at Maple Leaf Gardens. And here, the Leafs have built up a 5-3 lead in the third period with 3:57 remaining. And at the moment, Hartsberg of Minnesota is serving a major penalty as the Leafs come right in on top of Beaupre. Sticks go high, some pushing and shoving, and Hartsberg off for 5 minutes. High-sticking creature of the Leafs has 3:32 remaining on that penalty and only 3:50 remaining in regulation time.
Well, Rick Vai, very frustrated, has yet to get his first goal in the series. Had some good chances in Minnesota in games 1 and 2. Had a couple of opportunities here tonight, but the Leafs, in fact, we can consider this game one with the 2-goal lead, 3:50 to go, and being on the power play, be a good time for them to try to set the captain up and get him on the scoreboard.
We went into the third period tied at 3. Podupny scored at 5:51 and Boudreau at 10:42. The only scoring in the third period. So 5-3 Toronto with 3:45 remaining in the third period. Bobby Smith lugging it in for Minnesota. Roberts backs up. Mandich on the defense with him. Smith and McCarthy up front. Smith coming in. Smith very dangerous in this series, scoring big goals in the first two games at home in Bloomington. But here in Toronto, he has been silenced as the Leafs come in with that 2-goal lead. 3 minutes 15 left. And here comes the solving. Back to five. A bullet shot by five. And Beaupre covered the angle and made the save, and Five has been completely frustrated in this series.
Do you believe it? You know, I think maybe if Five had taken a quick wrist shot, he might have had a chance to beat Beaupre as he was out looking for Salmi, but he wound up with the slap shot, giving Beaupre just enough time to come back, but a big save by Beaupre. I'll tell you one thing, Bob. As long as Vive is getting the chances, eventually they're going to go in. The time to stop worrying or start worrying is when you're not even getting the goal-scoring chances. And Vive has certainly had his many, many chances in these three hockey games.
Miroslav Fritscher, receiving a high stick from Hartsburg, who was serving a major penalty, was cut on the neck. Controlled back on the bench stall. Lehman, shot, knocked down by Beaupre. Young Gary Lehman, number 16, playing in his first Stanley Cup game. He's the junior from Regina Pats. They have the All-Stars out there in the Western Hockey League. And there he is. Boudreau, Martin, and Gavin up front for Toronto. They have the man advantage. And the clock winding down for Minnesota as Gavin goes in, steals it. Gavin back to the net. Takes a look. Back to Lehman. On the other side, Salming. Into the corner, Boudreau. Back to the net to Gavin again. Martin is in front of the net. Now Gavin. Back to Lehman. To Salmi. They just whip it around inside, waiting for one good chance. It might be here. Off the outside of the post. Gavin shot. Martin flattening the free area. By Velashek. 2:28 to play. Regulation time. Lehman again. To Salmi. Salmi climbs up. Shot stop. It comes loose. Grabbed by Broughton. Boudreau after him. So is Martin. Maxwell played it up toward the line. Broughton gets away. A great move. Upended now. And a penalty coming up to the Toronto Maple Leafs. Beaupre racing out of the net. Minnesota lose control as Salming knocked it down the ice. So the Leafs will get a penalty right here with 2:01 remaining in regulation time. And the Leafs leading by 2 goals. Lehman goes off.
Well, you can almost count on Lou Nanny pulling Donny Beaupre out of here with 2:01 to go, and the North Stars on the power play. There is the reason for it. Lehman hauling down Neil Broughton. And the faceoff will be down inside the Toronto zone. I'm sure we'll probably have a timeout by one of the two coaches here. And Beaupre right now still in the net, Bob, but I wouldn't be surprised, as I said, that Beaupre goes to the bench. They've got nothing to lose, whether you lose by three or try to get back into it. It makes no difference. It's a game out of the way, and away you go for game four. But they're going to leave him in there right now. As Hartsburg, of course, is still in that penalty box with 1:43 to go. So we'll be four skaters aside right now.
And 1:55 left in regulation time. Shand plays it in. Minnesota back to pick it up. They don't have much time now to get back into this one. They're trailing by 2 goals, and they're coming in. Smith shot. Stopped by Paul Mathieu. The rebound is set up there. But Therrien, ever present, back there in his own zone, lugged it out across the line. Still has it. Therrien does not give it away. In for Harris. Therrien going off. He gets a big hand again. It's 2 or 3 times tonight now. He drew a hand from the fans. On a great shift and then going to the bench. Now the goaltender, Beaupre, is racing out of the net. Five has an empty net down there. So does Anderson. Anderson all alone. He scores. Ricky behind. Set it up for Anderson. That's his second goal of the night. And Mickey will be back here tomorrow night, 7 o'clock Eastern time, for game 4 of this series, as the Toronto Maple Leafs have opened up a 6-3 lead with 1:07 left.
So time 18:53. Another good hockey game, and this time
John
the Leafs
Anderson
come out on top.
From Rick Vive.
As Vive gave that pass to Anderson, and he broke in really unmolested. As Broughton just got a stick on him, but not enough to do any damage, and there Anderson just dumping it into the open side. So, game 4 is a reality. And, Bob, you never know. Now that the Leafs can that one win under their belt, boy, you might just happen to see a game 5 here very easily.
55 seconds to play now. Beaupre is back in the net. Martin is coming in. Here's Martin, and he's grabbed and pulled out of the play. by the Minnesota player, Broughton, who got back. There's Payne. His shot. All but here got back. 40 seconds left. The Leafs leading 6-3. Shan poking one across the Minnesota line. Minnesota winning the first two games at home by 5-4 scores. The second one in overtime. But here tonight, the Leafs staying with it. And they have built up a 3-goal lead here in the 9 seconds of the hockey game. Minnesota in after it now. Hartsburg's penalty over. He's back on with the Leafs. Boudreau to center. 8 seconds left. Took his shot in wide. And the clock winds down. The game is over. For the Maple Leafs extending the series to a fourth game tomorrow night. Ledubny, Boudreau, and Anderson, goals in the third period. The only scoring plays, and Mickey, they win it going away.
Well, they had to win this one. This was the big one. And now they can turn their efforts to tomorrow night in game four, and you know, the Leafs will be back strong again. They've got a little bit of momentum now. They finally get some breaks. They worked hard again, as did Minnesota. They've been great games in both teams, all three hockey games, and I'm sure we're in store for a dandy game here tomorrow night. As I said, Bob, could be very easy looking at game five on Tuesday night back in Minnesota.
So the final score of tonight's game is Toronto 6 and Minnesota 3.
Coke is it. Coke is it.
The most refreshing way.
Last Wednesday, when we talked, Mrs. Jensen, you made a promise. Watch.
Oh, you take it. All right, next headache, I'll try Anacin. Maybe it'll change my mind. Maybe it won't.
So, what's the verdict?
Oh, Anacin changed my mind, all right. Did it ever? I took just 2 tablets over 900 milligrams, right?
Right.
And my headache just took off, no problem. What do you say, Anacin adult strength?
That's right. Anacin has adult strength.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are your Molson three-star selections. The first star, Mike Palmateer. The second star, Greg Therrien. And the third star, Miroslav Preacher.
We'll return with Hockey Night in Canada in just a moment.
Out of a great beer tradition comes a great new beer. Introducing Export Light, with a distinctive light taste. A great tradition has come to light. Discover the taste of Export Light.
Well, the Maple Leafs said things would be different when they got back to home ice for 2 periods. That was debatable. But the Leafs scored all 3 third-period goals to beat the North Stars 6-3 and force a fourth game. It'll be played here tomorrow night at Maple Leaf Gardens at 7 o'clock Eastern Time. The 3-3 tie was broken by Walt Podubny's goal. It stood as the winner. Preacher and Therrien assisted. Then Bruce Boudreau got some insurance on a crazy sort of goal. Billy Harris just shot it toward the net. Boudreau was skipping in the air, trying to land on his feet, and the puck hit his skate, it appeared, and went into the net past Beaupre, and then the empty net goal at the end of the game, second last minute of play with the North Stars trying to get 2 goals back to tie, was by John Anderson. Mike Palmateer made a total of 47 stops in this game, and as we told you, the North Stars took 27 shots at him in the second period alone. The second star of the game had to be Greg Therrien. The way he has played in this series and ever since he joined the Toronto Maple Leafs makes you wonder why the Los Angeles Kings ever gave him away for a fourth-round draft pick yet. And Miroslav Fritscher has been the Leafs' star forward performer in all three of these games, and tonight was hardly an exception. Miroslav Fritscher is the third star tonight. This afternoon, the Islanders took a 2-1 series lead by beating Washington 6-2, Bourne and Trotche 2 goals each. Quebec stays alive at home and beats the Boston Bruins 2-1. The Winnipeg Jets are doggedly trying to hang into their series with Edmonton. They were 1-goal losers in Game 2 at the Northlands Coliseum. They are now tied against the Edmonton Oilers, and there are more scores, obviously. We'll try to get to those shortly as we go now up to the broadcast booth and Bob Cole.
Well, what a hockey game again tonight, Mickey. We said it from the very beginning. This series had all the earmarks of being one of the more interesting series of the lot. And it's sure turning out that way. The two games in Minnesota, humdingers again tonight with the Leafs winning it going away.
Well, this is the first time really in the series that any team has really jumped out to that kind of lead. And we mentioned Toronto having that 2-0 lead in Game 2 in Minnesota. But tonight it was a little different story. But I thought Minnesota sort of lost their composure throughout this hockey game at different times. They got frustrated by the Leafs, but I think it was to be expected. The Leafs would play somewhat more physical here at Maple Leaf Gardens than they did in Minnesota, and those two games could have gone either way. This one could have either, entering the third period, being tied at 3, but Toronto just stuck with it a little longer, and now, boy, you never know what can happen. You win that first one, and away you go tomorrow night, and momentum for Game 5, possibly.
We'll see what happens tomorrow. Let's go to Dave.
The first series to end was in Buffalo tonight, the Sabres eliminating the Montreal Canadiens in 3 straight games. And the star of the series was Buffalo goalie Bob Sauvé. Let's go to Buffalo.
Here in Buffalo, goaltender Robert Sauvé and the Sabres have eliminated the Montreal Canadiens. Congratulations, Bob, on a super sweep of the Canadiens. Tonight's hockey game obviously had to be the toughest of the three.
Thank you very much, Dick. Yeah, I think so. I think it was the toughest. They took the lead 1-0. It's the first time they got the first goal, you know, in that series. And it was tough. It was really tough. We came back and went ahead 2-1, and they came back, tied the score 2-2, and that was scary after that.
147 minutes and 25 seconds of shutout goaltending for you. Did you have any extra feelings when the goal finally went in?
No, not really. I wasn't expecting anything. I never thought about that, the record or something. I don't know why. I think those two shutouts in Montreal didn't seem to excite me that much. I don't know why. I think it's just because I can't believe it. I still can't believe it. So it wasn't a big thing, you know. I was just happy we won the game.
Made more tough saves here tonight than you did in the two games, I think, in Montreal. The Sabres' attitude, very briefly, Bob, going into it, you obviously had confidence you could beat the Canadiens.
Yeah, I think so. You know, if we knew that if we played together like we did, that we had a good chance to beat them.
And indeed, you did beat them. And again, congratulations on 3 super games and goal for Buffalo.
Well, thank you very much.
Robert Sauvé of the Sabres, who have defeated the Canadiens and eliminated Montreal. Now, back to Dave Hodge in Toronto.
We left off. Vancouver has beaten Calgary 5-4. That series goes on. Chicago leads St. Louis 2-0, and the Rangers lead Philly 4-1. The Rangers try to sweep the Flyers. The North Stars could not sweep the Leafs. This series goes to a 4th game. And again, it will be played tomorrow night at Maple Leaf Gardens, and it will start at 7 o'clock Eastern Time. Please join us. We know you will. If you've enjoyed this series to this point, and if you've watched it, you have certainly enjoyed it. Good night for all of us at Hockey Night in Canada.
CBC, Hockey Night in Canada, brought to you by Molson, bringing you the finest in hockey broadcasting for 25 years. Canadian Tire, there's more to Canadian Tire than tires. Canadian General Electric, we bring good things to life. Esso, responding to your needs makes us better, you make us better. And by Ford of Canada, at Ford, quality is job one, right down the line.
This program is protected by copyright and is intended solely for the entertainment and enjoyment of the viewing audience.
Reproduction by any means, in whole or in part, without the expressed written permission of Hockey Night in Canada is prohibited.
This is Barry Peterson of Boston Bruins, inviting you to join us Sunday night for our next Stanley Cup playoff telecast right here on CBC. Don't miss any of the action. Be sure to check your local television listings for the start time in your area of Canada.